This is SRN News.
What's the best way to bring people together?
T-shirts!
T-shirts. Custom T-shirts that you design online with custom ink. The fun, easy way to make shirts you'll love for your group or occasion. Custom Ink has created over 50 million shirts for families, teams, reunions, church groups, cheerleaders, companies big and small. So go online and see how easy it is to design your own shirts with Custom Ink's online design lab. Our website has tons of fonts and amazing artwork. And our team of professional inkers will make sure your shirts turn out perfectly. Order one shirt or thousands. On-time delivery is guaranteed, and we'll even ship your order absolutely free.
Start designing your Custom Ink T-shirts today and see why 99% of our customers say they would order from us again. Visit CustomInk.com.
The Obama White House is giving Vice President Joe Biden time and space as he weighs a possible presidential run. SRN's Greg Cluxton has more.
Press Secretary Josh Earnest says President Obama understands that the decision to run for the White House is an intensely personal one, and he says the staff has gone to great lengths to give the vice president the time and space he needs to make his decision. As for timing, Earnest says Biden has earned the right to make this decision on a time frame of his own choosing. Greg Clugston, Washington.
As recovery efforts underway in Victoria Harbor after a barge tipped as it was being loaded, dumping as many as 20 vehicles into the water, British Columbia Ministry of Environment says booms are in the water to contain any pollution, and the ministry says the Coast Guard, Transport Canada, the police, the fire and harbor master are all on the scene to try to get it all taken care of. This is SRN News. Authorities say a former Utah judge who was removed from the bench for being a polygamist has died after his semi-truck crashed down a ravine.
Police say 70-year-old Walter K. Steed's truck was likely at the bottom of the cliff for several days before it was found. Investigators believe he was driving along State Route 59 after leaving his home in Hilldale when the truck went off the road and crashed. Search and rescue crews found Steed's body inside the vehicle. Police are investigating what caused the crash. Steed was removed from his part-time judicial position in 2006 after an investigation confirmed he had three wives. Patrick Voss reporting.
British prosecutors considering corporate charges against Rupert Murdoch's News Corp over phone hacking at the now-defunct News of the World tabloid. Meanwhile, there's reports that former News of the World editor Rebecca Brooks, who resigned amid scandal, is returning to head Murdoch's British newspaper division. More details at srnnews.com. I'm Ron DeRockstra.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
There are hundreds of silver products on the market today, but there's nothing like the astonishing health benefits of the multi-patented One Silver Solution. Boost your immune system at a great price with our Silver Solution Liquid, starting at $12.95 a bottle, now available in regular and extra strength. That's half the price of the leading competitors. Call 844-USILVER for your free catalog, or go to onesilversolution.com, onesilversolution.com. There is only one Silver Solution.
Free Talk Live.
This is Free Talk Live. It is the live Saturday edition of the program. Of course, you're invited to join us, and you may bring up anything you like. That is why we call the show Free Talk Live. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've also got Skype. We'll give you that username here in a moment. And apparently there's been a sentencing recently of a 17-year-old, American, according to Gizmodo.com, sentenced to 11 years in prison for tweeting. Now,
it's going to have to be a pretty impressive tweet to get how many years? Seven?
11.
11.
He's 17, so he'll be 28 when he gets out.
Well, it depends on what's, is this a federal?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, so that's about 85%, so he could, yeah.
I don't know, can they charge you on a state level for terroristic charges? I presume they can, but.
I don't know the answer.
Seems like they're all federal cases.
Depend on the state.
The story, again, from Gizmodo's Matt Novak. American teenager sentenced to 11 years for so-called providing material support to terrorism. But Ali Amin, just 17 years old, never committed violence in the name of radical Islamic terrorism. His crime was running a Twitter account that celebrated the terrorist group and taught others how to send money through Bitcoin. Amin ran a Twitter account called @AmrikWitness with roughly 4,000 followers before it was shut down. I think he had more followers than we do. Maybe we got 6,000. I don't know. The account regularly posted positive tweets about ISIS and included tutorials on how to send money to them using Bitcoin.
I'd be really curious as to what positive things one could say about ISIS. I have a difficult time coming up with things that would be positive to say about ISIS.
Well, there was the propaganda series that they came out with John Cantley, who was basically...
They did surprisingly good journalism for a terrorist organization. Yeah, I'm willing to say that.
There's that. They got some real good video editing skills. And in the case of those videos with John Cantley, John Cantley being the British photojournalist who's been imprisoned by ISIS now for a few years, I'm sure they threatened him, and they had him host the series of different videos. Many of them were in front of a camera in a sort of a black room with nothing in the background except a drop cloth and him sitting at a desk in an orange jumpsuit. But then later they actually brought him out into the cities, and that's when they were trying to show their propaganda to counter the U.S. propaganda. Their propaganda is that, look, everything's fine under ISIS rule.
The buses are running on time. People are fed.
Are going to the market. They are trading. It's at business as usual here in, you fill in the city. He was in a few different cities where he did these sort of camera tours, and he was the host that would take the cameraman on the tour of the city.
It's still hard to compliment ISIS over that. I'd really like to compliment John Cantley.
Well, John Cantley did do a fine job, but he's not the one who is... I mean, I guess their point was they're not cracking down on... it's not hell, was the point they were trying to make, living under the ISIS rule. Now, whether that's true or not...
We might be the first caliphate in 1,000 years, but it isn't hell.
Yeah. Now, whether that is true or not is another question. That was just their propaganda. So, if you wanted somebody to say something nice about ISIS, you can go and look at their propaganda, and they will say nice things about themselves.
Gotcha.
The account did regularly post these positive things. The Virginia teenager also helped instruct one teenage ISIS recruit on how to get to Syria to fight for the terrorist organization. John Carlin, Assistant Attorney General for National Security, said in a statement, quote, ISIL continues to use social media and send their violent and hateful message around the world in an attempt to radicalize, recruit, and incite youth and others to support their cause. More and more, their propaganda is seeping into our communities and reaching those who are the most vulnerable. Well, so their propaganda is getting out there. Fine. Who cares? It's supposed to be freedom of speech. And if this kid wants to get on a Twitter account and talk about how ISIS is great, and if you want to send, ISIS money, here's how you do it, shouldn't he be free in a so-called free society? We all know it's not. But shouldn't he be at least free, theoretically, to go about supporting, with his words, a terrorist group?
Well, I don't know that I don't think so.
Before you answer, I'm going to give out our phone number. Okay. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We also have Skype. You may Skype in, and you'll sound almost like you're here in the studio with us. Skype username is lrn.fm. So wait, you said you think he should be prohibited from speaking his support for ISIS?
His support for ISIS is one thing, right? Like, I could go on Twitter right now and say, hey, ISIS is great.
You might get charged criminally for that.
I think that they're saying provided material support. And to me, what that means is he directed people to a Bitcoin account or hosted a Bitcoin account. I'm not entirely sure. It means that he told somebody how to go to Syria and fight for ISIS. Right? Like, so I think that there's some...
So you consider information to be material?
Well, I think that information is part of the definition of treason, right? Like, the Constitution has, I believe, four prescriptions for the federal government, and one of them is... to try people for treason. And so if I happen to come across the nuclear codes to the president's football, if they still have that thing, I don't know. It's probably laid in a vault at this point. But anyway, if I happen to come across the nuclear codes and I decide that I need to provide them to, say, the Russians, I can see why, you know, like, yeah, that might be considered treason by the people calling themselves the state. Like, that's going to be, this is a bad idea. And I wouldn't do this. I'm just saying, yeah, this is an interesting, this sounds like the definition of treason to me.
So are you saying that treason should be held in higher circumstance or whatever than freedom of speech?
They're both in the same document. And so
I'm not asking you what the document says. I'm asking you what you think. You're saying that treason, allegations of treason are, disobedience to the country or whatever, the idea of the United States, undermining that essentially that outranks freedom of speech in your mind.
When you place yourself in the middle of a war, and I think it would be difficult to
this
say
isn't a
that,
war. We're not at war.
Right. We're not at war, according to the document, but you just said you didn't give a damn about the document, so don't backtrack on me, all right? We are at a state of war whether or not the government has said it or not. Is that an accurate statement?
Well, certainly they're going around killing and bombing, so it looks like a war. It smells like a war, and it
and
feels
ISIS
like
has
a
killed
war.
Some Americans while they're at it, and a lot of other people. So when you place yourself in the middle of a war, do not be surprised when you are treated like an enemy of the state.
Mm-hmm.
And so, therefore, I have.
I'm not surprised. Okay. I'm not surprised they're going after this kid because they've gone after people for rap lyrics they've posted on Facebook. I mean, so that's not a surprise to me at all.
Yeah, I got to say that, I don't care. He's taken a side
really?
In this. Yes, I do not care. I think that at the point that you start picking a team and the other team goes after you, fine and dandy. This isn't a freedom of speech issue to me. Now, I'm
surprised by that.
I would like to hear a difference. I think there might be a difference between directing people to a Bitcoin account saying, hey, you can go to ISIS.com. And
it says here that he taught others how to send money through Bitcoin. Now, this is Gizmodo's summary of the story.
Yeah.
So, you know, I'm presuming they're accurate about that. So maybe he just gave a Bitcoin address and said, here's step 1, 2, 3. You do this and this and this to get Bitcoin and then send it to this address, even though he didn't control the address.
That would be an interesting difference to me. And as his defense attorney, that would be a really important thing that I would point out. Like, if I, as a talk show host, say that you can go to, ISIS.com, I hope that ISIS does not have ISIS.com. I have not looked at ISIS.com. But you can go there and you can provide material support to ISIS. If I give information to people, I think that's a different story than encouraging or hosting or doing a variety of things. So if I told somebody, this is how you go to Syria, and maybe I want them to go to Syria to provide medical or humanitarian aid to people, I think an American should be able to go to Syria if an American wants to go to Syria.
Well, he supposedly gave teenage ISIS recruit information on how to get to Syria to fight for the terrorist organization.
Yeah,
but again,
it's
still just information on how to go somewhere. It's information on how to do something. And look, even if you disagree with what this guy supports, I certainly don't support ISIS. I don't support any kind of state, which means I also don't support the American state either. And is that a treasonous statement to make?
Well, I can look at two sides. As a person who does not support either any organization calling themselves a state, I can look at two different states and I can say this state appears to be worse than that state.
Which one's worse?
I'm going to have to say that I'm thinking ISIS is worse.
I don't know about that. 855, 453.
They've killed fewer Americans than the American government has.
Yeah, they've killed fewer people worldwide than the American government has.
Yeah, but I wouldn't trust
lot
them. But
fewer.
I wouldn't want to be an American in wherever their place is.
855, 450 free. This is the Live Saturday, Free Talk Live.
Understanding your credit score is the first step towards managing and improving it. This is Charlie Sundstrom with your Van Dyke Mortgage Minute. The most influential component of your credit score is your payment history. Almost equally as important is the amount you owe on credit accounts. Also impacting your score, but to a lesser degree, are the length of time you've utilized your credit, the number of new accounts, credit inquiries, and your various types of credit accounts. To help achieve or maintain a healthy credit score, have a system set up to assure your bills are always paid on time. Don't max out your cards. It's better to have a high credit limit with a low balance. Never close old accounts. The age of these can actually help your credit score. But don't be afraid to use your credit. You need several accounts in order to have a credit score. Just keep the corresponding payments within your means. For your mortgage pre-approval and refi needs, start by visiting VanDykeMortgage.com.
Corporate NMLS 3035. Van Dyke Mortgage is an equal housing lender. Charlie Sundstrom, NMLS 134251.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CatiArmor.com. Come and take it.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy and get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99 and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
Silver has always been nature's very own antibiotic, and only one system allows you to produce an endless supply of nano-sized silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. Silver Lungs. With the addition of our unique lung delivery system, respiratory infections are targeted directly, where traditional oral administration simply cannot reach. This pioneering method also preserves the original particle sizes and delivers your silver solution directly into the bloodstream. See the Silver Lungs generator and lung delivery system at silverlungs.com. That's silverlungs.com.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
We're here for Free Talk Live, which is where we'll take your calls about whatever happens to be on your mind. Although, certainly, if you've got an opinion on the 17-year-old American who is now being sentenced to 11 years in prison for basically running a Twitter account where he celebrated ISIS and taught others on how to send money to ISIS via Bitcoin, he's now going to prison, and you can share your thoughts toll-free, 855-450-FREE. I say that freedom of speech is more important than this precious idea of treason. And Mark, you seem to be on the other corner, which I'm a little surprised about.
I'm unsurprised, and I feel like if he didn't come over the line of treason, he found it, right? Like and he looked at it and maybe put his little toe over it, that kind of thing.
So we'll get to you with your calls and thoughts. Also want to let you know about ProXPN. If you care about privacy while you're online, you need ProXPN. So, you know, if you're going to be running some sort of questionable Twitter feed.
Run a questionable Twitter feed is the first place to start.
Well, and it's important to have freedom of information out there, Mark. So if you're going to be trying to get information out there, it's good to protect yourself. And ProXPN can help you with that, whether you're on Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, or Linux. They can help you encrypt your data connection, which means your internet service provider won't know what you're doing online anymore once you're using ProXPN. ProXPN also does not keep logs of your activities whatsoever, and they've got more servers than ever before, giving you greater speed and security. They offer OpenVPN, which is the gold standard of network encryption. You can get 50% off the regular monthly price for the lifetime of your account when you buy an annual account with our code FTL50. That's FTL like Free Talk Live and 50 as in 50% off. So you keep hearing about your online privacy being infringed. Go to proxpn.com now and use code FTL50 to take back the privacy that is your right. Let's go to Kathleen listening in Madison to the mic 92.1. Hey, Kathleen.
Hi. I was shocked when I heard that this kid got 11 years in prison. I'm just looking at it. Okay, 17-year-olds have crappy judgment. He did something that, I would question material support. He sort of enabled other people to provide material support.
Mm-hmm.
But I think I get back to that freedom of speech, and it's kind of a mixed thing. I think I would make some other sentence that seems more appropriate, where he has to serve a year in prison and wear an ankle bracelet for 11 years and is completely denied access to the internet. I mean,
it's a heck of a lot cheaper.
So basically, freedom of speech is really just, it doesn't mean much to you, right?
Freedom of speech means a lot, and it is a question that I can't say when all I've seen is the internet, but what that report is. So it's really kind of, I think at that point it's kind of nuanced, but I am definitely down more on the side of freedom of speech. Like, yes, you can say this is treason, but when you look at what the politicians get away with saying, that I can't believe that, we're definitely on for them. They're defining freedom of speech. They can say all kinds of treasonous things, but not this 17-year-old kid who, his brain's not even finished cooking yet,
I think you're coming from a good perspective here that, he deserves some level of forgiveness and understanding, but government doesn't work that way generally. They crack down, and they crack down hard. Maybe he made a mistake, maybe he regrets it, but all that aside, he didn't really hurt anybody. He just simply allowed people to support an organization that the U.S. government has decided they don't like. And so I don't care what the dude says. If you should be able to get on Twitter and say whatever it is that you want to say within Twitter's rules. And, if you violate Twitter's rules, then they can ban you. But as far as freedom of speech is concerned, I think that the idea of freedom of speech is that you're supposed to protect the offensive speech. You're supposed to protect speech that is outrageous. Because if you start to crack down on that, then it's a real slippery slope.
And he didn't provide any information that you can really say is treasonous. It's not like he said, this is how many airplanes are parked at the base right next to my house. He provided people with open access information they could have gotten from anywhere else. So they're really condemning him for intentions. And that's the whole point of the freedom of speech issue is, I can see some amount of sentencing. But I think they're just trying to make an example of him and teach everybody, hey, you know what? Shut up. You're not allowed to have any intentions other than ours, us, the U.S., the biggest terrorist state in the world.
That's a good point. So, Kathleen, good thoughts. I appreciate hearing from you tonight. Let's go to Straight Razor in Texas.
I think
Texas.
It's worth defining terrorist at this point. And I think it's fair to call any government a terrorist organization because they, including the Islamic State and including the U.S. and all of them out there, because what they do is they threaten people to get compliance. So if you are scared of the threat, if you're terrified of the threat, you fit the that organization fits the definition.
Terrorism is the use of violence and threats to intimidate or coerce, especially for political purposes. I mean, that is to a T what governments do. All governments, especially the U.S. Straight Razor is in Texas, and you're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Straight Razor.
So let me get this right. So somebody supported another movement or government or whatever. And if you want to sway them to your side, the government thinks the best course of action is to lock them up and make them incredibly unhappy.
Yeah, this is proving the point that the U.S. government is evil. And so if he ever had any doubts about that, now it's real crystal clear.
I'm sure it's to him that's the case.
Exactly.
That's what I'm talking about, to him.
All we've done is confirm what he already thought, you know, in his mind, because now we're attacking him. But here's the thing, is that if you're going to start attacking people based on what you believe their intentions are, where does that stop?
I totally agree. This is a really scary concept. You also had the story about the teenager they picked up, I think it was the Chicago airport, who was leaving to try to fly over to the Middle East to supposedly join ISIS. They charged him with some sort of, you know, aiding and abetting or terrorism charge or whatever, and he didn't light a fuse on a bomb or shoot anybody or do anything. He could have gotten over to Syria and then had a pang of conscience at the last moment and thought, oh my God, what am I doing here? And turned around and gone home.
Had his head cleaved off.
But they never got, you know, they never allowed him to have that that opportunity to make his own change of mind. Instead, they're just locking him away.
I tend to agree because, I mean, you know, with a crime, it seems like you should have that moment when you decide before it happens whether or not you're going to carry this act out. And, you know, if they carry the act out, then they're guilty of the crime. If they don't carry the act out, then at that point you have this sort of planning to do something, and that's something entirely different.
Exactly. So I can be, let's say I'm angry with Mark, and I can wholeheartedly in my head think, you know what, I really want to hurt Mark in some way. And I can be 3 feet from you, and then all of a sudden decide, you know what, I'm being irrational.
Yep.
And this is not the right thing to do, and turn around and walk away.
Or you just don't have the guts. So, I mean, some people just don't have the guts for violence, right?
Exactly.
That's kind of the point of prison.
We remember a while back whenever they were getting all those letters from people who had gone to Syria and supported ISIS. And they're writing all these letters back asking, please let me back in because this place is horrible.
So, yep. Thanks, Straight Razor. Good call, man. I appreciate hearing from you. It's Free Talk Live.
Global warming covertly describes the effects of iron poisoning. CO2 is iron poison blood types and is the body's defense mechanism to buffer the oxygen iron attracts. CO2 in blood and blood type prevalences are used as false evidence for global warming and is the setup for the greatest fraud in history. The healthy blood type AB is on the Shroud of Turin and is their DNA proof they are his Christ. For further information, unveilingthem.com, unveilingthem.com.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are FortressSurvivalLLC.com.
Are you tired of commuting to a job that makes someone else...
Hello, Pac Maniac.
Hello.
Hi there. Where are you calling from?
I'm from the UK. I've got a point sort of on a Campbellian idea of people not being able to change their ways, and they should be regarded by libertarians as enemies.
Okay. Stand by.
And be earning money as soon as next week. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss. Get out of the rat race. Work from home. Go to freedom106.com right now and change your life today. That's freedom, the number 106.com. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You be the boss. Go to freedom106.com.
You're old enough to tell that something is definitely wrong. You've been paying attention for years and you're ready. You're probably frustrated because your children don't listen to your words of warning. What will you do when your grandkids show up hungry at your door? Get more food storage from Ready Supply Foods. We sell 50% more food for your dollar, and we can prove it. See the comparisons for yourself at ReadySupplyFoods.com. We're the new leader in value and quality. Go to ReadySupplyFoods.com today.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live. You may join us here toll free. 855-450-FREE. If you think this 17-year-old should go to prison for 11 years for running a Twitter account that favored ISIS, ostensibly gave instructions as to how to give money to ISIS via Bitcoin, and just, you know, posted positive things about ISIS. If you think that deserves any time in prison, I'd really love to hear from you. Mark, do you think this guy should go to prison? You seem to think that this was treasonous.
Well, I think that I'm unsurprised. Please characterize my position as it is. I am unsurprised that when he picked a team that was other than the United States team, like if he told people how to, you know, that, yay, the United States is great, and how to give money to support the troops, and how to, you know, go and sign up for the U.S. military, clearly there wouldn't have been a problem. He did the opposite of that. And
he supported the other terrorists.
Right. And he lived within the U.S. borders. Now, if he would have gone ahead and moved to wherever ISIS
is. He's 17.
Look, I mean, you know, I moved out of my house when I was 17. I'm sure those folks...
Well, they arrested that dude when he tried to go out to where ISIS was.
He was providing people with information on how to go join ISIS, so he clearly did not believe the information he was providing enough to go do it himself. If he cared, believe me, the people over the Islamic State will take care of him enough to put a gun in his hand and give him someplace to go catch bullets. So, you know, yes, he has picked a team, and he is reaping the consequences. I am unsurprised.
Do you think he should go to prison?
I think that other things should be tried.
Re-education?
Somebody mentioned the ankle bracelets or something like that. I think that when you're dealing with someone who has not harmed anyone, that the first place that they should go is to looking at, you know, recompensing the victim. I don't really know who the victim is.
There is no victim here.
And
there's no crime.
Well, fine, right? Like,
kid committed a crime, Mark, then so do you every night on the every night of the week on this radio program.
I do not give people instructions on how
you have violated your allegiance to one sovereign or one state. That is the definition of treason.
Fine, I have violated.
You just
that
said
allegiance.
You do not support any state
I
earlier
do not,
tonight.
Do not support any organization that claims a monopoly privilege on a use
nice
of violence.
Nice knowing you, buddy.
Fine. However,
lock him up.
I've got a business, and because I have a business, I do understand how IT works. I understand that IT can be very difficult.
You can barely log into your computer.
I understand that IT can be unreliable, unpredictable, and late. Do you understand that?
Oh, sure.
Are you frustrated by
IT
work?
There's a few things that are more frustrating than a bad IT manager. Because they can really botch it up.
Yeah, they sure can.
And charge you a bunch of money.
So, if you deal with these sorts of things on a relatively regular basis, consider Root Work Infotech. They help businesses achieve always-on reliability, keeping your customers happy and your staff productive. Root Work can make IT meet your needs, and to prove it, they'll give you 30 minutes on the phone with a senior consultant for free to answer your IT questions. So they're going to give you free information. That's what they're in the information business. Free information, just go to rootwork.it/FTL, that's FTL as in Free Talk Live, to get your free call. It's rootwork.it/FTL, rootwork.it/FTL.
All right, so I think that if you support freedom of speech, and a lot of Americans talk about supporting freedom of speech, but then when someone starts saying something that makes them feel uncomfortable...
This makes me feel uncomfortable. I will certainly admit that.
All of a sudden, the whole free speech idea goes out the window and they start clamoring for some kind of a crackdown. And the thing they don't realize, if you're one of those people that supports cracking down on this young man for having an ISIS-supporting Twitter account, the thing you don't realize is you can rattle the saber all you want at these people, but eventually there's a good chance the government's going to turn around and criminalize some sort of thing that you're talking about.
They probably already have criminalized.
There may be some topic or issue that you consider to be very important that eventually you speaking your mind about could be considered a criminal act simply because you weren't there to stand up for the people who were being picked on the first time around. And I think that's what's happening here. This is outrageous to me that anybody could go to prison for running a Twitter account. Let's go to Pac Maniac on the Skype. Hello, Pac Maniac, calling from the UK.
I've got a disagreement. Well, it's basically a libertarian idea. Say, for instance, where you live in New Hampshire becomes a anarcho-capitalist republic. Yeah. And you happen to have people who advocate that the rest of the United States should do exactly the same as what you've done, but in New Hampshire. Do you understand where I'm going with this?
So let me see. You're saying New Hampshire secedes from the United States?
Yeah, say New Hampshire secedes.
Yeah.
And the Free State Project gets what it wishes to be, the achievement of it, which I'm in favor of, by the way, yeah, that it's anarcho-capitalist, or, you know, even if it's only just minarchist to very minimal levels, how would the new state deal with people wanting to infiltrate it with different ideas?
So your question is, I just want to make sure I'm following you here. The New Hampshire secedes from the United States. How do the other 49 states deal with people from New Hampshire bringing their small government or no government ideas into the other states?
I'll make it more clear. What happens when the people who don't want New Hampshire to succeed walk into New Hampshire and say, we want it to be different? We want it to be a status site again. Do you understand?
Yeah, no, I see what concept you're saying. So you're saying that New Hampshire would reach some sort of libertarian utopia, and then, you know, what happens when people come in and they want to create a state again?
Just walk,
I got you.
In.
Thank you for the call, Pac Maniac. I appreciate hearing from you. What do you think, Mark?
Well, first off, the Free State Project is a project to move 20,000 liberty-loving individuals to New Hampshire in order to create a society where the maximum role of government is the protection of life, liberty, and property. I think that this has been pointed out by the creator of the Free State Project, Jason Sorens, as probably one of the most interesting problems that faces New Hampshire in the future if the Free State Project is successful and creating a state that has smaller government.
It barely exists.
Yeah. Right. If people come and want to, basically what they would have to do is that every state has a constitution, right? So you write on a piece of paper, you make it very difficult to roll, to increase the size of government. Therefore, the people who come and try to increase the size of government may only increase it through violent means rather than using the agency of violence, which is the state. And that would be the answer to that. It's going to be difficult to get enough people inside the legislature to change the Constitution, but that's supposed to be the point.
Well, right. It's already difficult to get enough liberty-minded people to move to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project. It's taken more than a decade to get to, around 17,000 participants, I believe. And we want to hit 20,000 is our goal. So it's going to take at least another year or two to get to 20,000 people.
It sounds like a good problem. I'll sign up for this problem.
What do you mean?
That good to problem. Have the problem of success and then maintaining success.
Yeah. Right. So the problem is getting to even the goals that we're looking to reach are very, very difficult. It's hard to convince people to uproot their lives and move somewhere else on the potential that maybe something will be better in the future. Now, I think that we've already proven that the Free State Project works. It's a proof of concept. We've got people who've been elected. They've helped roll some bad laws back and stop some bad laws from being passed. And there's a real it's a real success story so far. And I think that eventually, if we do get to this libertarian or voluntarist utopia that our caller was talking about, then you would have to be a real dedicated statist to get out someone who loves the government. You'd have to leave your state, then move to New Hampshire, a place where there's all kinds of people there who love freedom and are willing to work against you. To what, start some sort of movement to overturn it all? I mean, that seems pretty unbelievable.
When statism is merely 33 miles away, I don't care where you are in New Hampshire, statism is 33 miles away, and for the Brits over there, let's call that 50 kilometers, then why would a statist spend that kind of time?
Yeah, they'd have to spend time, they'd have to spend effort, money to come up here and then face loss after loss after loss. Ultimately, that's what we're doing, right? Like, we're spending time, effort, and money and, having a real tough time at this. But it's worth it to us. Would it be worth it to your average statist or to your above average statist? That's a weird term. 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Also, free speech. This is Free Talk Live.
This is a life-changing message for anyone with sleep apnea who is on the go and tired of dragging around a big, bulky home CPAP device. MiniCPAP.com now offers a portable device that's as small as a soda can and weighs less than a pound. For even more freedom, you can add a battery that's as tiny as a deck of cards. It's called the Transcend Mini CPAP, and right now you can try it risk-free for 21 days by calling 1-800-939-8536. Transcend is the world's first portable mini CPAP device. It gives you the freedom to sleep in total comfort anywhere you are. Our smallest and most advanced portable design ever, Transcend, is so small and so light you can fit it in your briefcase or purse to use anywhere you go. It's FAA compliant too, so you can even sleep comfortably while flying. Enjoy the freedom to sleep comfortably anywhere. Call MiniCPAP.com now for your 21-day in-home trial. 1-800-939-8536. That's 1-800-939-8536.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
You are an individual with your own thoughts, decisions, and actions. So why should you be penalized for not enrolling in the subpar health insurance mandated by the government? Be truly independent. Visit libertyoncall.org. Libertyoncall.org is a bold, innovative alternative allowing you to take back control and make your own decisions about your health care. Mention this ad when you call to learn more. 800-714-6993. That's 800-714-6993. Libertyoncall.org. Call today.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Mike Stenerson from Midas Resources. At no time in history have precious metals been more important, certainly not in my 22 years in the industry. The dollar has lost over 90% of its value in the last 60 years. No fiat currency has ever survived the government printing presses. Ours is not immune. The time is now to be proactive. 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Anything tied to the dollar is at risk. CDs, annuities, 401ks, IRAs, stocks, bonds, you name it, so decide. Do you want to leave a legacy of wealth or debt for your family? The choice is yours. Call me at 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. That's 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Be proactive, not reactive. Call 1-800-686-2237, extension 116.
So I say to Mark at lunch, look, you know, I keep hearing from the government that, you know, they're worried someday ISIS may get here. And I go, duh, Garland, Texas, Muhammad cartoon shooting, ISIS is already here. I'm not waiting for these people to defend me. If they don't know ISIS is here already, they got no clue, I'm taking care of myself. Guns80.com, AR-15 kits, 30-shot magazines, great prices. They've even got the Hillary special. Guns80.com, that's 844-2-GUNS80, Guns80.com.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition continuing, where you can dial us up toll-free and bring up anything that you want. The number is 855-450-FREE. Main story on the table, though, tonight that we brought in to discuss is this 17-year-old person in the United States who is now going to prison for 11 years. He ran a Twitter account, and I understand people say some offensive things on Twitter.
That's what I hear.
I get that, but it shouldn't be a criminal
act. I haven't
been
properly cussed out on Twitter, frankly, though.
It should. Do you have a Twitter account?
I do.
It shouldn't be a criminal act. And you can share your thoughts with us at 855-450-FREE. Don't forget, you can also join us online. We've got a website, and go to freetalklive.com, and you can actually create the content there on the front page of the website, whatever news, maybe a YouTube video, something fun, whatever you want, whatever you think our listeners will appreciate, you submit there to the front page of the site, and then you can vote up or down whether you like or dislike the various things that are listed there. So go and get interactive at freetalklive.com. As we go to the phones and your calls and thoughts, John, listening in Indiana to WIBC on FM. Hey, John.
Hey, how are you guys doing?
Welcome. Doing great. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Okay. I wanted to start out with a couple comments and then ask you a question. First
sure.
of all, this idea that you guys have, which is, well, at least one of you guys has, which is that free speech is free speech, which means all speech should be protected. That's not even factual when it comes to the Constitution. It's already been ruled on by the Supreme Court in 1919 when they said that, for instance, yelling fire in a crowded theater, or at least falsely yelling fire in a crowded theater, is unconstitutional, is not protected under the Amendment for Free Speech.
That's different because there you're on private property. And a private property owner can reasonably restrict whatever it is they want as far as your behavior on their private property.
Sure, you can't come to my house and yodel underneath my bedroom window because you're on my property and you're disturbing my sleep.
And I'm not saying that Twitter isn't private property. Twitter is also private property. So Twitter could certainly have a rule that says you're not allowed to advocate for violent groups when on Twitter, and then the appropriate response to someone breaking a private property rule is to remove someone from private property. So the appropriate Absolutely. Response would be to ban him from Twitter, but not put him in prison. Right. What do you think?
Well, you're absolutely right, but the reason I quoted that Schenck versus the United States of America in 1919 was because that was actually in reference to anti-draft protesters, and the government decided that protesting against signing up for the draft was not protected under free speech. So I just kind of wanted to put that out there and then go on to my next point, which
I think
was,
you get into a really dangerous area when we say that, and this is one of the problems with the Constitution as a document. I do not hold this thing up as handed down to George Washington on Mount Vernon and he brought it down on a lambskin and gave it to all of us. I think that it is a flawed document. So one of the problems is that things that are plainly written in the document are then interpreted by government bureaucrats. And that's what the Supreme Court is. They don't run for office. They're not politicians. They're bureaucrats.
Right.
They're a high-level bureaucrat.
If a living document. That's why they call it.
You could call it a living document if that's what you want to do, but it's never taken a breath. It's a piece of paper that is interpreted by 5 out of 9 government bureaucrats dressed in black muumuus who could say anything that they want if they want to. I mean, they're completely, there's no punishment for what it is that they say. They could say the sky is plaid, and that would then be constitutional. So that's one of the real problems with the document. I don't believe that they understand what free speech is. I believe I understand better.
Okay, well, see that right there. I mean, that's kind of that's what I'm looking for here. Like,
treason.
Basically, that's like kind of a nihilistic view or like a central view of your life. You basically think that you know better than them. And all I'm trying to say is that free speech has been already for almost 100 years now, for 96 years at least, defined as, okay, yes, you can have your free speech, you can support what you want. And with this guy, I don't care if he supported, you know, ISIS. That's his business. And by the way, this is coming from a U.S. military vet. I was in the Marine Corps for 5 years. I don't care what he supports. Where I think he crossed the line was when he actually provided information as to how to support them. And the only analogy I can come up with to make this make any sense is that's like in 1939, somebody, if the internet existed then, trying to give information to Americans on how to support the rise of Adolf Hitler in Nazi Germany.
I'm reasonably certain some powerful Americans did that without too much punishment that came their way.
Well, if you're a powerful American, then you probably can afford attorneys who can defend you in cases like this. But wait, here's a related question for you, John. You're calling this... you're concerned with what he was providing, the information he was providing. What about the Anarchist Cookbook? You can find this thing still. It's been around for decades. This has information about building bombs and other things that can hurt people. It has information about drugs, but, you know, more specifically about building bombs is what I'm interested in here. Should it be illegal to provide people with information on how to build bombs?
Well, it would depend, but honestly, right off the top of my head, I would say yes.
Wow. See, you don't support freedom of speech. I mean, clearly. And that's sad.
You can go on the internet and find it.
That's sad to me, because freedom of speech is really important, because we have to protect unpopular speech. We have to protect bomb-making instructions. We have to protect the horrible racist speech out there and the other things that many people don't like, because as soon as you start to crack down on speech you don't like, eventually it's going to come back around on you. Thanks, John, for the call tonight. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Maybe you don't believe that's the case. Maybe you think that you'll always be exempt from whatever the rules and regulations are surrounding free speech or surrounding restricting speech. But
well,
I'm not willing
to
gamble.
I don't expect to be on the other side of the ISIS versus U.S. Conflict, whereas I think that the United States, like any government, is antiquated technology, in that it is a service organization that claims a monopoly privilege over a given landmass. It is passed down to us through the master servant paradigm that was probably in existence before the agrarian revolution, but certainly 20,000 years ago with the agrarian revolution came slavery. And, you know, when you have to, you're born into an organization, you have to support that organization, and that organization claims the fruits of your labor and claims your property, which governments tend to, well, then... that's what that organization is.
Let's talk to Tim in Bowling Green. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Tim. Listening to WKCT.
How y'all doing?
Welcome, sir.
Enjoying your show.
Thanks, you're on the air.
I'm not educated enough to answer your question, but I do have a question that's related.
Sure.
What is your opinion on how do you stop ISIS and radical Islam in general? I mean, what's your solution?
Well, good question. That's a really good question.
Yeah, it's a great question. I would say that, first off, if Baghdad can't protect itself, then Baghdad doesn't deserve to exist. King George, 200 and something years ago, couldn't prevent the U.S. colonies from seceding, so therefore King George didn't deserve to rule over those people and tax those people. That's those people's business, and it's not yours and mine.
Well, if I can make a comment, sure. They're already coming to America, and if they get control over there, then they're going to get bigger and bigger. And we are sitting and watch people get lined up on a beach and beheaded just because they're Christians.
Yep.
Their four-year-old children are being raped in front of them before they kill them. And we as a country over here... read up on them. I mean, it happens every day. It's a bloodbath.
Somebody can always say something on the internet. I mean, that's why they put video out. So that beheading is plenty. Let's just stop there.
Well, yeah, beheading's enough. Yes, but they are raping their children. They're doing things that's barbaric.
Go join some sort of Christian legion and go, fight them on your own. I'm not interested in supporting war.
The U.S. has allowed people to go there and fight for the Peshmerga and against ISIS.
What keeps them from coming here if they get bigger?
Well, why would they come here? If the United States didn't get involved in their business and didn't fly remote control airplanes over their towns and villages and drop bombs out of the sky that they didn't even know were coming and kill their children, because you're worried about kids being raped and people being killed, I'll give you some assurance. The United States government is participating in child rape over in Afghanistan. There is plenty of documentation on it. And the United States government is killing people in Afghanistan with remote control airplanes. You won't deny that because you do know some of the news over there. So, we don't look so great over there either. You're scared of them because of the news you're getting and because this is your society. They're scared of you for the same reason.
Because a Christian there is the same thing as a Christian here. We're all Christians, if you are, and I don't know if you even are, but assuming you are, should Christians here ignore the fact just because there's an ocean between here and there?
Let's talk about being a Christian and dealing with ISIS. If you want to stand by, Tim, I'd like to bring you back after the news. This is Free Talk Live. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. What's the appropriate Christian response to these alleged violent people?
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you, or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Breathe it in, kid. Every 3 months, we install these air handler filters. They're more energy efficient, hold more dust, and are priced to save us more money. And Granger's got close to 3,000 different styles and sizes to choose from, in stock and ready when we need them. I love oxygen, kid. And this facility's got some great AO2. I'm breathing easier just thinking about these air handler filters. Get some today. Get it? Got it? Good. Call clickgranger.com/filters or stop by. Granger, for the ones who get it done.
It's time to build your own emergency food stockpile with the industry leader, My Patriot Supply. Once you try them, you'll know why so many Americans like you have made them part of their emergency preparedness plan. Experience the My Patriot Supply difference today with this unbelievable offer. Right now, a 4-week food supply is only $99, and that includes free shipping. That's 50% off the online price. Call 800-274-3070 to claim yours. Limit 2 per caller while supplies last. This offer isn't available online, so you want to make sure and grab this opportunity to get prepared today. 800-274-3070 to get your 4-week food supply for the incredible price of only $99, and it'll be shipped to you completely free. Call 800-274-3070 right now. That's 800-274-3070 to claim yours while supplies last. Don't wait. Call today.
Exposing the lies. USA Prepares with Vincent Finelli. GCN.
With SRN News, I'm Ron DeRockstra. A 30-year-old man's facing capital murder charges after authorities say he gunned down a Harris County, Texas sheriff's deputy in cold blood. Sheriff Ron Hickman says troopers and police made quick work in capturing Shannon J. Miles.
I'm proud of the men and women that have worked swiftly to apprehend the responsible person who posed a significant threat to both the law enforcement and community at large.
Hickman says Miles allegedly approached Deputy Darren Goforth from behind and shot him multiple times Friday night, even as the deputy fell to the ground. Hickman says there doesn't appear to be any reason for the attack.
We have not been able to extract any details regarding a motive at this point.
Hickman says on the surface, it appears that Deputy Goforth was murdered simply because he was a cop. Also at SRNNews.com, celebrations and remembrances on Saturday, 10 years after Hurricane Katrina unleashed its fury on Louisiana and Mississippi. Louisiana Governor Bobby Jindal says continuing the rebuilding efforts is an appropriate tribute to those who died in the hurricane.
Those who were lost in the storm and its aftermath will never leave our memories. They inspire us today and every day. We will carry the torch of resiliency and recovery in their honor.
In the Caribbean, at least 20 people are dead, another 50 missing after Tropical Storm Erica blew through the island of Dominica. Forecasters say Erica's diminishing now, but its remnants can still bring heavy rain from Cuba into an already saturated southern Florida late Sunday into Monday. And dozens of San Quentin prisoners are under observation after an inmate was diagnosed with Legionnaire's disease. Weekend visits have been curtailed and drinking water is being trucked into the prison. Portable shower units arrive today for inmate use. The prison has about 3,700 inmates and some 1,800 employees. This is SRN News.
What's the best way to bring people together?
T-shirts!
T-shirts. Custom T-shirts that you design online with custom ink. The fun, easy way to make shirts you'll love for your group or occasion. Custom Ink has created over 50 million shirts for families, teams, reunions, church groups, cheerleaders, companies big and small. So go online and see how easy it is to design your own shirts with Custom Ink's online design lab. Our website has tons of fonts and amazing artwork. And our team of professional inkers will make sure your shirts turn out perfectly. Order one shirt or thousands. On-time delivery is guaranteed, and we'll even ship your order absolutely free.
Start designing your custom ink t-shirts today and see why 99% of our customers say they would order from us again. Visit customink.com.
A judge has ruled against an Oklahoma death row inmate whose attorneys were seeking to halt his upcoming execution for the 2002 killing of his 9-month-old daughter.
District Judge James Bland denied the request by Benjamin Cole's attorneys on Friday. They wanted Bland to order the prison warden to find that Cole was insane. Cole's attorneys claims he's not sane enough to be executed. They're expected to appeal the judge's ruling to the Oklahoma Court of Criminal Appeals. The 50-year-old Claire Moore man is said to be executed by lethal injection October the 7th. He was convicted of first-degree murder in Rogers County for killing his daughter, Brianna Cole. Patrick Foss reporting.
Michelin's recalling around 104,000 BF Goodrich commercial and rugged terrain tires because sidewalls can rupture under severe use conditions. The recall involves tires made in 2014 and 2015 and primarily sold in the U.S. This is SRN News. A judge won't throw out a lawsuit challenging Virginia Fairfax County's police department's practice of storing data collected through the use of license plates readers.
The ACLU claims that keeping a database of such information amounts to an illegal invasion of privacy. Fairfax County Circuit Judge Grace Carroll denied the police department's motion to dismiss the lawsuit. The decision came 2 days after a state trooper used a license plate reader to identify the suspect in the slayings of WDBJ-TV reporter Allison Parker and photographer Adam Ward. The ACLU says using a plate reader that way in a criminal investigation is proper, but routinely compiling data from law-abiding Virginians and sharing it among police agencies is not. Keith Peters reporting.
A California doctor known as the Candyman has been convicted of illegally prescribing painkillers that led to 20 overdose deaths. Dr. Julio Diaz testified that patients lied to get the drugs. More details at SRNNews.com.
There are hundreds of silver products on the market today, but there's nothing like the astonishing health benefits of the multi-patented One Silver Solution. Boost your immune system at a great price with our Silver Solution Liquid, starting at $12.95 a bottle, now available in regular and extra strength. That's half the price of the leading competitors. Call 844-USILVER for your free catalog, or go to onesilversolution.com, onesilversolution.com. There is only one Silver Solution.
By now you know that wireless technology like cell phones do in fact pose dangers to the health and privacy of everyone. Blockit Pocket's wide range of products are unmatched in providing the protection you deserve. No scare tactics, just common sense. BlockitPocket.com offers quality American-made options to alleviate and eliminate these invisible dangers. Learn more at BlockitPocket.com or call 888-315-9618. BlockitPocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
Free Talk Live.
This is Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition continuing here. You're welcome to join us at 855-450-FREE. Should a 17-year-old young man be sentenced to 11 years in prison for running a Twitter account that was favorable towards ISIS? That's pretty much what's happening. The story coming from Gizmodo.com. We can tell you more about that here in a moment, but that has sparked a conversation tonight about the idea of terrorism and the state, or have I repeated myself? Because the state is essentially terrorism. If you look up the definition of terrorism, it is the use of violence and threats to intimidate or coerce, especially for political purposes, which, of course, is an exact description of the United States government, your local state government, your local city or town government, every other government in the world. That's how they do so-called business, is with the threat of violence and actual violence to intimidate you into paying their taxes, into following their stupid ordinances and rules and regulations. So that also led to a conversation with Tim, who has kindly held through the news as we requested. Thank you, Tim, for sticking with us here, because you'd asked a question about, you mentioned that you're a Christian, you're concerned with this so-called radical Islam, the ISIS folks, and you were wondering about the idea of, well, you know, if we, the people in the United States, don't go over there and kill people, then that will result in them coming over here. And that was sort of what your question was, but I want you to be able to rephrase it. So go ahead. What were you asking before we went away?
I just think we can't put our head in the sand and act like there's not a problem, because there is. And they've already been here. They're coming here. I mean, 9/11, I don't know if that was ISIS per se, but same thing.
Well, no, it was not ISIS. But in point of fact, the Taliban actually came out recently and said that the ISIS—
Al-Qaeda.
No, it was actually the Taliban who came out recently and said that the one of the more recent ISIS videos was absolutely despicable and horrifying. And so even the Taliban, who was supposedly one of the bad guys within the last 15 years, has come out against ISIS.
It has gotten worse.
And the reason why it has gotten worse is because the U.S. government continues to go over there and meddle in those people's business. You know, would you be upset if the Chinese government came in and started bombing your neighborhood? How'd you feel about that?
I wouldn't like it, but I don't think as Christians, and the majority of people in America, black, white, Hispanic, are Christians, the vast majority, and to step back and let other Christians, just because there's an ocean separating us, just to ignore them and not help them, I think is wrong. My first question is, if they see ISIS coming, why don't they have some guy like Paul Revere up the road say, hey, they're coming? And I know these villagers don't have guns, but why don't they buy some dirty guns and fight their own battle? I understand that. But I think if we just sit back and put our head in the sand, it's not going to get any better. And one solution I have—
Well, hold on. Before you go on, you've made a positive statement here, which is you don't think it's going to get any better. But the United States has been involved in Middle East politics since at least the installation of the Shah of Iran in, I think, the 50s. So, you know, what we know is that the U.S., the CIA, and other intelligence agencies meddling in the business of the Middle East destabilizes people. And along the same time as we're doing this, people become more radicalized towards Islam. So the reasonable thing to do would be to cease that behavior and see what the results are. The United States government
what if they continue to wiping out Christians?
What if they turn into Tehillah monsters and fly into outer space? We don't have any idea what they're going to do if we stop being involved. But I would encourage you to do this. Get together with your Christian friends and go over there and fight them yourselves. Because this would be completely constitutional.
I would rather protect our borders better and get more strict on watching them, the ones that are here. And most experts will say anywhere from 12 to 25% of Muslims are radical Islamists.
I don't know which expert you're listening to, but that doesn't sound right
ridiculous.
To me.
What do you think the Christian response should be as a, you know, a Christian is somebody who's supposed to emulate Christ?
Let me tell you one answer. With all these race issues we've got, the Christian-Muslim situation, and this is biblical if you believe in the Bible, it says you'll be asked to deny Christ, your throat will be slit. That's already happened. It's happening today. And we are turning our back to it, and we're fighting about the color of our skin. Blacks, Hispanics, and Caucasians need to get together, all as one race, and we'll call it the Christian race because most of us are, and forget about the color of our skin. Then we've got the numbers to be more influential, I guess.
Who would Jesus kill? Are you saying that the Christians should get together and go kill people in the Middle East? And that's going to make things better?
I think we should kill ISIS. I always find it ironic.
Would Jesus go out and kill people?
I don't know.
You don't know? You don't know? Look, man, I was raised Christian. I'm not a Christian now. I am religious, but I don't subscribe to the Christian religion. But I think I have the basic understanding, having gone to a Christian camp and church and such as a young person. I think it was pretty clear that Jesus was about turning the other cheek and forgiving and loving your enemy. And going somewhere, hunting someone down and killing them doesn't sound like something that Jesus would do.
I just don't think you can just sit and watch people land up on a bench and watch them get shot in the back of the head.
I'm not advocating for you to go to watch that.
That's not my problem.
I get it. But here, let me ask you this. You've been very clear that you know that you didn't know whether you're a Christian. And I will say that I'm not Christian in the traditional sense, but I am sort of in part of the greater Christian tradition.
You're a Quaker.
Right, I'm a Quaker. And I have no interest in participating in this war or funding this war. Who do you think you are? As a Christian and as an American, to force me to fund your stinking religious war, sir?
Well, I don't know. And that might not be the right answer. I don't know. I don't know the answer.
Well, that's a fair answer. I'll give you that one. Thanks, Tim, for your call tonight. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Let's go to James. He's in Loras, South Carolina. James, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, how's it going?
Welcome, sir. You're on the air.
I wanted to talk about freedom of speech, but after listening to the last caller, I kind of feel compelled to, you know, make a few points, just possible if I can, on your show.
Sure. Go for it.
One, it's not the Christian belief to go out and kill anyone. It never has been and never will be. I mean, one of the main Ten Commandments says very clearly, thou shalt not kill. It doesn't give a if in this case, we'll let it be okay.
All right.
Now, mind you, I am a retired naval personnel. I have been to Baghdad, Iraq with the service when I got rented out to the Army in a quote-unquote way. So I have been there, and I have been there when we were trying to help, in a sense, you know, level the country out a little bit as far as, you know, trying to lessen the evils over there. Now, that being said, I'm not going to sit here and say that I 100% supported the war, okay? But my fellow brothers and sisters and myself, we were there to try to at least help through the situation. I don't know whether or not we should have ever been there. I don't know whether we should still be there. I do know that when we left, we did leave it in a very severe state of disrepair, which I think was a negative thing too. But I'm not going to get on Obama's decision to do that or not. That's, you know, that's in the past, and there's nothing we can do about it. Now, as far as ISIS goes, what I will say is it's not a Christian, a Muslim, a Jewish, a Hindu thing to go out there and try to destroy another race. It is a human nature thing to go and try to help stop any evil in any form from existing. Okay?
Yes, absolutely. And I think that it's completely within your rights to go and help people who need help around the world.
Right.
What is not within your or anyone else's rights, or at least should not be, is to force me or Mark or anybody else who doesn't support your particular conflict. Maybe, you know, we're just peaceniks or whatever, and we just don't want to get involved, or we don't agree with that particular conflict.
I may very well support the guy that went over there and fought for the Peshmerga. I'm not sure.
Right. But I, for instance, am not interested in supporting war, and so therefore it would be wrong for you to threaten me with violence in order to get me to pony up money so you can go and have a war. wouldn't it?
Oh, I don't disagree with that. Yeah. And my big thing with the matter is, unfortunately, as a prior service member, I have the luxury of knowing that the people who get to make the decisions of whether we do or do not go to war, 90% of the time, have never wore a uniform. And everything looks quote-unquote good on paper.
It's a lot easier to send somebody else to die for you than
somebody
yourself. That's certainly true. Thanks, James. I appreciate it, man. 855 450 free, the live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live.
Attention, business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO? MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767.
Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
Healthy, organic, fresh fish, robust, mouth-watering vegetables, all from your home. It's called aquaponics. This brilliant, self-sustaining protein and veggie system is perfect for year-round growing. Know exactly where your food is coming from. AquaponicsSource.com is the one-stop shop for all your needs. Fish, fish food, plumbing, full systems, classes, and more. Learn to build your own system. Go to AquaponicsSource.com for a free guide to aquaponics. That's AquaponicsSource.com.
We all know that Berkey Water Purification Systems are the most trusted name in water filtration. As an authorized Berkey dealer for over 6 years and serving thousands of satisfied customers, the Berkey Guy offers amazing specials for Berkey Water Filtration Systems. The Berkey Light Systems include a set of self-sterilizing and recleanable black purification elements that purify water by removing chlorine, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, and parasites to non-detectable levels and remove harmful chemicals such as herbicides and pesticides. Order the Berkey Light System today, complete with two black Berkey elements for only $231, and the Berkey Guy will ship your order free of charge. With the purchase of a Berkey Light, the Berkey Guy is also offering a set of fluoride and arsenic filters for only $39.99. That's over 30% off the retail price. Call the Berkey Guy at 1-877-886-3653. That's 1-877-886-3653. Or order online at GoBerkey.com. That's GoBerkey.com today.
Now a twice-as-nice Twin Kit special offer from Complete H2O Minerals for all GCN listeners. Get a Complete H2O Minerals Twin Kit with 33 different minerals, vitamins, and amino acids all in a liquid form. Enough for two people for 1 month. Regular price $89.95, but now Complete H2O Minerals is offering the Twin Kit for $69.95. And all GCN listeners receive a bonus 16-ounce bottle of Ionic Silver absolutely free with free shipping. A $120 total value. Hurry, limited time offer. Call 803-794-4767 or click CompleteH2OMinerals.com.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is the live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live. We allow you to bring up anything you want to discuss. You're welcome to do that here, 855-450-FREE, or we can certainly continue to discuss the 17-year-old who is now going to prison for 11 years for running a Twitter account. Whatever you think about ISIS, I would hope that you understand that freedom of speech should be protected no matter what the content of the speech. And I don't care if the government doesn't like the content of the speech. I think that it doesn't matter. If we care about free speech, you got to just put it aside, however offensive, however outrageous the content might be, and just allow it. You have to allow others to be free if you want that freedom for yourself. Now, if you don't care about freedom and you don't mind being controlled or owned by another human being, then by all means, you can advocate whatever you want as far as crackdowns are concerned. But if you, on one hand, claim to support freedom of speech, but then on the other hand, support putting this young man in prison, you actually don't support freedom of speech. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. ExpressCoin is the best choice for getting cryptocurrencies, including Bitcoin, Litecoin, as well as Dogecoin. It's fast, safe, easy, and it's inexpensive. They are a licensed money services business. You can get cryptocurrency with money order or check. Start off at ExpressCoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, they can help you at ExpressCoin.com. Sorry, New Yorkers. You can even do it from your smartphone by downloading the app at ExpressCoin.com, and you can use coupon code FTL to get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no fee at all. ExpressCoin.com, coupon code FTL. And if you happen to be in one of the few places in the U.S. and Canada that ExpressCoin cannot service, there are ways to get around that, and ProXPN, which we explained to you earlier, could help you there. So don't forget, ExpressCoin.com, coupon code FTL, like Free Talk Live. Let's go and continue with your calls and thoughts. We've got Chris. He's in New Jersey. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Chris.
One, capital K, capital V, lowercase t, capital
no,
A.
No, 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 no. You don't get to read an entire Bitcoin wallet ID on the air.
Well, you just defeated my purpose for, well, actually you haven't, but so the reason I was reading that Bitcoin address off was because I wanted to demonstrate how quickly you can become a terrorist in this country. I definitely think that freedom of speech outweighs any other law that they can possibly pass. Without freedom of speech, you don't have a democracy. The government can come in and they can basically control what everybody hears and what everybody thinks, and what everybody will the government will ultimately, the people who will be in government who will end up making the decisions. You might not like ISIS. They might be doing horrible, horrible things, but that's no excuse for censoring speech. Or even contributing potentially financially, we should all be entitled to contribute and support whatever groups
right.
we want. That's what it is to be an American.
It seems to be a fundamental factor of being an American. And even court decisions sound very free speech oriented. There are court decisions that'll say things like, I'm paraphrasing, obviously not reading directly from one of them, but freedom of speech is one of the most important bedrocks of the United States, because the United States allows you to criticize your own government. You know, this is one of the things that freedom of speech is supposed to be for, right? Where you can say things about the politicians without having them lop your head off or put you in a prison cell. But in certain circumstances, those same courts have ruled that, well, free speech should be attenuated because the government's interests are just too important on this particular issue. And the Schenck case the guy called in earlier about, I had heard the name, but I wasn't familiar offhand with what it was. I pulled up the Wikipedia article about this, and it was from 1919, as he said, where the court in this case, the Supreme Court, concluded that defendants who distributed leaflets to draft age men urging resistance to induction could be convicted of an attempt to obstruct the draft, which is a criminal offense. So the act of simply handing a flyer to somebody who was, you know, going to join the military under the force of the draft, encouraging them to resist that, was an act of was a crime. And the U.S. Supreme Court backed it up and said, yeah, free speech doesn't apply here because our draft –
is more important than freedom of speech. And there have been other cases that have been, you know, since then.
What a surprise. The government says that, you know, certain speech against the government is unacceptable.
Right. And so it's all an illusion.
The since idea the Bill of Rights is just a piece of paper, what are you going to do? Yeah.
The idea that you have free speech is just an illusion. And I suspect you're going to see less free speech over time rather than more if things keep going in this direction. Chris, anything else you want to share? Go ahead.
Yeah, I sort of wanted to veer off on an unrelated topic, if that's all right.
Briefly, sure. Go ahead.
It is related to freedom and speech and all that. Have you guys heard of the Save Wi-Fi campaign?
I have not. Is Wi-Fi in danger?
Yes, it is. So it's actually not specifically Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi is basically being used as the excuse to control what you can do on your computer and your devices and so forth. The FCC has passed and is attempting to pass new rules that require manufacturers to lock down the devices, lock down your devices that you buy so that you can't swap the software, change it for different software.
That's terrible.
Yeah, it's absolutely terrible. And basically, right now, there's basically a campaign going. Again, the site is www.savewifi.org. Mm-hmm. And basically, if you go there, there's instructions on how you can comment and what would be good to say even.
So sending even a public comment to the FCC, they usually have these public comment phases where they allow people to beg them for whatever it is they want them to do, that kind of thing.
Yeah, exactly. Now, there's going to have to be a much longer campaign than just this, but this is basically the start. There was a huge thread on Reddit today on this exact issue.
And, yeah, it must be a big deal because it's actually total coincidence. There's another guy on hold who wanted to talk about this exact issue, and I don't think you guys coordinated this campaign. Is there like a big calling campaign to call radio stations or something?
No, there isn't.
Maybe there should be.
I
mean, this
is
a big deal. Well, now, why should people care about this? Like, the average person listening, you know, they don't ever go in their router and change out the firmware. That's what you're talking about doing here, which I've done because I'm a techno geek. I'm running DDWRT here, which is a custom firmware.
Seriously, DDWRT?
Yeah.
You bad mamma
jamma?
It's
a custom firmware that you can upload to a bunch of different routers that actually give you better router software. There's more options and, you know, more geekery going on in there, and it's cool to do that kind of thing. It makes things work better in a lot of cases. But Chris, why should the average person listening care about this? Why should they go to savewifi.org?
So yeah, I mean, this is actually a great question. You're not affected only if you decide to switch out your firmware. A lot of the code that the manufacturers are utilizing is what you would call a free software, or sometimes people refer to it as open source. Mm. But basically what this means is that everybody has the rights to make changes to it. Mm. And the developers who maintain this software and contribute to the software can't do their job if they're locked out of their devices, which means that they can't fix bugs. They can't ensure that there's security on your device. That, you know, if you want to see a mobile,
sounds like a mess, Chris. Thanks. We'll send listeners to savewifi.org. There's more Free Talk Live.
Turn on the news and you'll hear stories of natural disasters, political unrest, and financial crisis. In times of uncertainty, how will you take care of your family's most basic needs? Food Insurance, America's most trusted provider of freeze-dried emergency food, has solutions that fit your family's needs and budget. Our meals are delicious, nutritious, and come with a guaranteed 25-year shelf life. For a limited time, we are sending a free freeze-dried meal to all listeners of this program. Go to foodinsurance.com and request your free meal today. That's foodinsurance.com.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order, Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CatiArmor.com. Come and take it.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
So I say to Mark at lunch, look, you know, I keep hearing from the government that, you know, they're worried someday ISIS may get here. And I go, duh, Garland, Texas, Muhammad cartoon shooting, ISIS is already here. I'm not waiting for these people to defend me. If they don't know ISIS is here already, they got no clue, I'm taking care of myself. Guns80.com, AR-15 kits, 30-shot magazines, great prices. They've even got the Hillary special. Guns80.com, that's 844-2-GUNS80, Guns80.com.
Okay, honey, I have to ask, and be honest here. Have you been taking a little blue pill? Because things have been pretty good in the bedroom lately.
No, I swear.
You didn't pick anything up at the Pharmacia last month in Cancun?
No.
Well, something's different.
I have been taking that heart and body extract you bought me.
But that's for your heart and to control your cholesterol.
Well, I read HB extract also promotes healthy prostate function.
I never guessed it would work this well, but...
You're glad it did.
Oh, yeah.
Heart and Body Extract is a 100% organic formula that promotes a strong heart, healthy arterial flow, better circulation, improves erectile and prostate gland function, and provides youthful energy, strength, and stamina. Find out more at heartandbodyextract.com. Heart and Body Extract, paired with healthy heart choices, is a winning combination. Call toll-free to order or for free information. 1-866-295-5305. 1-866-295-5305.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress. Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC.com.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live. Join us here toll free. Bring up whatever happens to be on your mind at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can take control of the airwaves. You can also take control of your wallet if you've got Bitcoin. And save big time on Amazon. This is the catch. You have to have Bitcoin to get 20, 25, maybe even more than 25% off at Amazon on pretty much all of your favorite items. Whatever you're looking to buy, as long as it's fulfilled by Amazon, which means it's got the free Super Saver shipping or the Prime, it'll pretty much work at Purse. Now, what you do is you go to saveatpurse.com. There's a real quick video you can watch there that'll explain how the process works. Not a very large learning curve here. It's worth taking the time to go to saveatpurse.com. If you can save 20% on every single purchase you make at Amazon, would that be worth looking into? I think so.
Yeah, I think what people don't necessarily realize when you say Amazon, because I don't buy that many things. You know, I didn't buy that many things on Amazon sort of prior to this, but Amazon has just about everything you need to live life. So if you can save 20% on just about everything you buy, that's something to really look at.
It sure is. So get started at saveatpurse.com. When you go through that link, Free Talk Live does get a very small portion of future purchases that you make from saveatpurse.com as we continue with your calls and thoughts about what you want. Dan, listening in Virginia to WNIS. Hey, Dan.
Thank you for taking my call.
Welcome.
Tonight, I hope that you'll use your station, which you certainly don't have to do, to let me exercise a little free speech right. And I'll tell you what, I'm 56 years old, and this is the first time in my life I've ever been afraid. But first, I would like to address what a caller a few calls ago said about we need to gather up as Christians and protect our borders. I'd like to address that, if I could, please, briefly.
Yeah, please.
The Jewish people, every time that they lost their nation, including the last time 2,000 years ago, one of the major charges held against them was that they didn't treat their immigrants correctly. They were charged with, holding them as slaves, doing whatever it was that they wanted to do. So I'd like to say
I thought
that
the Bible said you could do that.
You can, but if, and again, you can use the scriptures to say anything.
Indeed.
Right?
Yeah.
Indeed, you can. But one of the charges was these people want to come to your land, they want to join you, and they want to be a part of who you are. And instead of teaching them who you are and letting them enjoy with you, you treated them as slaves. Therefore, you lose in your nation. Happened at least 3 times.
Okay.
Okay. And where I'd like to take that from is this, Donald Trump. Is that okay to go there?
Sure, man. It's Free Talk Live. Go ahead.
Thank you.
I'm not sure how you're going to tie them together, but I do want to hear that. So go ahead.
I hope that I get this right. Okay. We see, first of all, I'm a white boy from Maine, New Hampshire. Okay. But I'm married to a Hispanic woman, have been for a long time. And I see Donald Trump rising up. And again, he has his right to free speech, and he has his billions of dollars to be able to buy and say whatever it is that he wants to say. We don't have that. We only have the right to free speech and hope that people like you who have radio shows will let us come on and say what we can with no money other than we listen to you.
Mm-hmm.
Donald Trump is using fascist methods to rise to power. He finds a group of people to blame for America's problems,
yep.
And that is the Latino population.
Yep.
And then, of course, he tries to intimidate the media, and he shows absolutely no regard for anyone in Congress or anything. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. Here's the part that's scary for us. We understand history, what happened in Germany, what happened in Italy with Mussolini, and that he is blaming, again, this population of people who have done no more than immigrate to this country like everybody else. And he's saying if we just get rid of these people, our land will be better.
Yeah, wasn't he talking about, I saw some ridiculous headline today where Trump was wanting to bring the head of FedEx in if he was elected and have him explain how they could track immigrants in the United States.
Because FedEx can track packages?
Right.
Is that the idea?
Ridiculous.
Well, the federal government. Oh. Well, I would agree with him in so much as the federal government is a poor agency to be attempting to track immigrants or illegal immigrants or whatever. Because, governments are poor agencies to pretty much do everything. So I'll agree with him in as much of that.
Well, I'm with Dan on this. I think this guy is definitely bad news. Using immigrants as a scapegoat is a common political tactic. But is he really that different from the rest of the Republicans on this? Maybe Jeb Bush is a little better than Trump. But these guys are pretty bad news across the board, aren't they?
Well, that's where I'd like to go there, if I could, please. And this is where your show gives us free speech, and we can't thank you enough. Okay? So Donald Trump said some pretty terrible things, and the Republicans, unfortunately, now we're teaching they're talking about the long-term effects on the Republican Party. We're teaching our children, please, never, never vote Republican.
Republicans really do this. They've really done this on a few different issues. They seem to find the most unpopular views and just pound away at that. And this is the demographics of America are changing. It was a couple of years ago where there was a minority of white babies born. So it is a reality that the demographics of the United States are changing, and the Republican Party can either be on the winning or losing end of that. Many people coming from other countries are socially conservative individuals, and Republicans could enterprise on that if that's what they wish to do. But instead, they act xenophobic in many ways.
Hey, Dan, great call, man. I appreciate hearing from you. The toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. Yes, I understand you had more to say, but so does everybody else. Let's go to Randy listening in Texas. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Randy.
Hey, how are you guys doing?
Welcome, sir. You're on the air.
Hey, no, I appreciate you guys' radio show. You guys give people a lot to think about. But, hey, I wanted to talk about free speech and how people, you know, you read the Bill of Rights, and it's not written in Arabic. It's not written in French. It's not written in Espanol. It's written in plain, simple English. And, you know, the freedom of speech, I mean, what more do you need to say? So, I mean, if somebody gets hurt from something I say or something somebody else says, that's their problem. That's not my problem. If you can be hurt by something I say, then you obviously have something going on in your mind and brain that says, that hurt me. I mean, words, I mean,
sticks and stones
might break my bones, you know, and so on and so forth. So it really bothers me, especially this guy on Twitter. I mean, like you guys were saying, he showed everything that he wrote about was visible for anybody who wanted to go see. And this guy gets 11 years in prison for something he tweeted? I mean,
it's insane.
It blows me away.
Well, there's also the reporter who was sent to prison for a few years because he was in a chat room giving out links to, what was it, torrent websites or something like that, or like some credit card, some downloaded credit card information. I mean, so there's all kinds of ridiculous impositions on our freedom of speech. There's the people who've been arrested and put in jail because of a Facebook post. They, you know, they quoted some rap lyrics on their Facebook post, and that was seen as a threat against police. And so, I mean, it's just
people filming police.
Yeah, that they're getting in hot water too. Actually, I had a story tonight about that. That there's a crackdown in various different places on people recording video of the police. We still haven't gotten past that one yet, even though it's been upheld by a number of courts that you should be able to record the police. Randy, I share your concerns and thank you for your call and thoughts here tonight. Let's talk to Craig, listening in Indy to WIBC. Hello, Craig.
Yeah, as I've been listening, I've been hearing what everybody's saying, and I kind of resonate with the guy who called two calls ago about Trump being kind of Hitler-esque. He's very passionate, and he talks about things that bother people, but he blames it on a specific minority, and that's where I have an issue with it. But also, America has an incredibly difficult immigration process, and we need to streamline it so people who are living here illegally can become legal citizens and pay taxes.
Craig, stand by. I'll bring it back here. I've got actually another headline. I've spent the last 15 years trying to become an American. I've failed. Written by somebody who's trying to go through the process. It's Free Talk Live.
It's fall flooring season with incredible deals on the hottest styles right now at Lumber Liquidators Fall Flooring Kickoff Sale. Choose from over 400 great floors with over 20 laminate styles like American-made mahogany for just 49 cents a square foot, more than 30 bamboo floors like carbonized bamboo for only $1.59, and over 150 hardwood floors like pre-finished gunstock oak for only 99 cents with a dollar off Bella with 20% off Dream Home laminates, plus great floors, woodlike tile, vinyl, and more with 24-month special financing. The Fall Flooring Kickoff Sale is going on now. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
You are an individual with your own thoughts, decisions, and actions. So why should you be penalized for not enrolling in the subpar health insurance mandated by the government? Be truly independent. Visit LibertyOnCall.org. LibertyOnCall.org is a bold, innovative alternative allowing you to take back control and make your own decisions about your health care. Mention this ad when you call to learn more. 800-714-6993. That's 800-714-6993. LibertyOnCall.org. Call today.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
Do you owe the IRS money? Has the IRS garnished your wages or put a lien against your house? The IRS has the power to make you pay back what they claim you owe and will stop at nothing to collect. There is a solution. Call Signature Tax now. Speak with our professionals and feel the weight of your tax burden lifted from your shoulders. Call now for your free and confidential analysis. 800-481-3147. Again, that's 800-481-3147. 800-481-3147.
Gold isn't for you?
Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms.
I get it.
You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold. For the realist, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30% while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should too. Find out what they know. Call us and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
We the People grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition. We, of course, allow you to bring up anything you want to discuss. That's why the show is called Free Talk Live. Of course, we always bring topics to the table, and freedom of speech has been one of them here tonight, spurned on by a story on Gizmodo.com about a 17-year-old who's going to prison for 11 years for running a Twitter profile that was favorable towards ISIS. Our toll-free number, if you want to join us here, is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Coming up, Keenvention is right around the corner. We are 2 months away from what is a very intimate affair here in New Hampshire. If you've ever been to a hotel convention before, then you probably have some familiarity with the idea of panel discussions and keynote speeches and banquet dinners and things like that. There's some of that that happens at Keenvention. We've got the panels, we've got the speeches. We don't do the banquet dinners. You got to go out and feed yourself. There's restaurants all around Keene. That encourages people to get out of the hotel and go explore Keene. Now, why do you care about Keene, New Hampshire? Well, if you're interested in the Free State Project, if you're interested in liberty, if you're interested in activism and being a better activist, learning activism from the people who are on the ground, who are getting it done, whether it's in the state legislature or cop block, we're going to be covering all kinds of different activist subjects at Keenvention. Keenvention is a convention for activists thrown by activists, and that's what the focus is on, whether it's creating your own media as an activist or it's just, you know, getting out there and hitting the streets and doing stuff like Robin Hooding. You actually can go out and fill people's parking meters on a Robin Hooding expedition during Keenvention. So it's an intimate convention, which means that they're usually going to be around, in the last couple of years, around 100 people, just over 100 people who attended over the entire weekend. That means you can get to meet everybody. The people that you see that are speaking at Keenvention, Chris Cantwell, our co-host, is going to be one of the keynote speakers. We've got dozens of other great speakers as well. Daryl W. Perry, another co-host on Free Talk Live, will be keynoting the event. You can go and get a list of some of the speakers and the panels over at keenvention.info. But that means you get to actually meet that person. If you've ever been to a convention before and somebody like Ron Paul is speaking, then you know they get mobbed by people when they get off the stage. And they only have enough time to meet so many of the people who are talking to them. At Keenvention, you get to meet everybody you want to meet. There's no doubt about that. And go to keenvention.info. You'll also get access to the Hallow Keen costume dance party with your Keenvention ticket, which is all of $60
or Bitcoin. So if you want to pay with Bitcoin, you can do that too at keenvention.info. It's happening October 30th through November 1st. I'm looking forward to it. Unfortunately, Mark, it's looking like you might be on a business trip during that that time.
At least a portion of it.
Yeah, but we're going to have a good time anyway because there will be dozens of liberty activists there from across New Hampshire. And if you've been looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire during the fall, this is a perfect opportunity. Go to keenvention.info. As we go back to your calls and thoughts, we've got Craig on the line here. And Craig, continue. You were sharing some of your thoughts with us a moment ago. Can you briefly recap for people just tuning in?
Well, I was just saying how the United States tends to have an extremely long wait line for people trying to apply for citizenship. And we need to kind of streamline the process. But I don't know how you would do that.
Here's how I would do it. Abolish the immigration department.
Sure. Okay, but here's my question.
Great.
I'm not trying to say that we need to track people because America should be a place of for free human beings. Mm-hmm. It is a place for free human beings, but we demonize certain people. Illegal immigrants being one of them. And I've got to tell you, just a side note, I'm a conservative 24-year-old, and I don't like Donald Trump in the least. I think he is a fool. The essence of a fool. He shouts and screams what people want to hear, but I think he is an idiot. And he will not get my vote, period. But that being said, how do you get people who just come in freely to do what Americans are expected to do, and that is to pay taxes?
Well, I would prefer they not pay taxes. I don't want to pay taxes. Why do you want to pay taxes?
Well, it's the law of the land. Render to Caesar.
So you're afraid. You're afraid they're going to hurt you.
The federal government doesn't own my money.
No, I'm not afraid that they're going to hurt me, but what I'm saying is
you should be, because if you don't pay your taxes, they're going to put you in prison, and if you don't want to go, you're going to get hurt.
No. I do pay my taxes,
right,
so
but
I'm not afraid of the government.
Do you pay? So you pay the taxes because you support the system?
I pay the taxes because that's what I'm required to do by law.
Meaning that if you don't do it, they're going to possibly kill you.
I mean, laws are threats of force, right?
Well, look. I'm not afraid to die. Okay, I'm not saying that I'm like out a gun-toting American who's out like looking for a fight. Like what I'm saying is I'm not afraid to die because I know where I'm going. But we as Americans have the privilege of living in a country that is free, and our rights are questioned daily by radical groups as well as our own government.
Yeah, I've got a greater concern for what the government is doing than any other group of people out there. They're the ones who are threatening peaceful people on a daily basis. They're the ones who are killing innocent folks. They are, as you've pointed out, preventing good folks from coming here and making a better life for themselves.
Right.
So I certainly will agree with you, Craig, that the system needs to be, if there's going to be a system, it needs to be much easier for people to get through it. Thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you.
I would deviate from your let's abolish the immigration system statement to something a bit more. If you're going to abolish the immigration system, and I'm fine with doing that, I think that there's some things that could be done that would make it freer, but fine. If you want to abolish it, that's great. But you need to consider that there's lots of other things that need to be abolished at the same time. You need to abolish the welfare state because you don't want to get a bunch of people coming here and just
living off of... I'll abolish the entire state.
Right. That's what...
I'll press that button right now.
That's an important
Where's
thing.
Where's the button?
That's an important thing to understand. You want to abolish the state. Now, I think there should be a much more gradual move into whatever...
Well, there likely will be because things don't happen all at once.
They certainly don't. But another thing you need to consider is the U.S. foreign policy is also in danger. Injured, people in the United States. I mean, people on 9/11 were killed because of their government's foreign policy. You don't want to just open up the border and continue the foreign policy. So there's a variety of things you might need to do before you just open up your border.
Well, if I had the chance to get rid of any government bureaucracy, I'd press that damn button. I'm not going to wait around until somebody else figures out how to get rid of some other bureaucracy before. I mean, if I could somehow press a magic button and have true freedom to travel here in the United States, meaning people could leave. They could be free to leave without having to ask government bureaucrats permission, because that's the other side of border controls, is that you don't get to leave very easily in a controlled border situation, if at all. And so personally, I'm not interested in the police state that is inevitably going to come with people like Donald Trump and others who want to crack down on supposed illegal immigration. But let's talk to John, listening in Indy to WIBC. Hello, John.
Hello.
Hey, John. You're on the air.
I just want to start off by saying in June of 1971, I took an oath to uphold and defend the Constitution of the United States, okay?
Against enemies foreign and domestic.
Against enemies foreign and domestic, and there's one right now. Never mind. But anyway, on this 17-year-old, okay, I agree, 11 years is ridiculous for his crime. But, yes, he did commit a crime, and the crime that he committed by putting this information out where people could send money to ISIS, who has been noted as a terrorist group and an enemy of the United States. His crime was aiding and comforting the enemy just by putting that information out there.
Well, let me ask you this. If we reported here on Free Talk Live, we're at least quasi-journalists, we comment on the news at the same time as we report it.
Right.
If I was to say, hey, there's a website out there where people can give – it's outrageous. People can give money to ISIS if they want to. And then I shared with you that website. Call it ISIS.com. I don't know what's at ISIS.com. I don't mean to
– probably a porn site.
Besmirch them. Yeah,
I'll
probably. Take a look. But
okay.
If I was to give that information out – in an informational way, what would that be, aiding and abetting?
Okay, my personal opinion on that is aiding and giving aid and comfort to the enemy, because you are giving information to people who are likely to aid and comfort. So essentially, after the fact.
An accessory after the fact?
All right, how about this one, John? I have played ISIS propaganda videos on these radio waves.
We've commented on it.
Yeah, should I be in trouble?
I would say yes.
Thanks for the call tonight.
You know they put that on the regular news, right?
That's sick, dude. Thanks for the call. You got to support free speech across the board.
Well, I don't support what ISIS has to say about themselves, and we've said as much during the video that it's horrifying.
Supporting free speech doesn't mean agreeing with the speech that's being spoken. 855-450-FREE, that's the toll-free number here, and you can join us for Free Talk Live. Hour number 3, coming up.
When the leading antihistamine and Nasacort go nose-to-nose, Nasacort wins, stopping more of the chemical responses that can cause your nasal allergy symptoms. And when you stop more causes, you get 24-hour relief from sneezing, an itchy runny nose, even congestion. It's prescription-strength medicine available over-the-counter. Nasacort Allergy 24-hour. Stops more of what makes you miserable. Use as directed.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Do you have difficulty taking supplements? Are you searching for a high-quality, complete nutritional drink that your whole family will love? NutriMedical's Life Support has arrived. All of your daily nutritional requirements in one quick, delicious drink. Dr. Bill Deagle's Life Support is a proprietary blend of vegan protein, activated vitamins, essential minerals, amino acids, probiotics, green tea, digestive enzymes, anti-inflammatories, cancer prevention, detoxification, and much more. Your body will high-five you for this one. Life Support is the best complete nutrition meal replacement on the market. Whether you are an elite athlete, have post-operative challenges, chronic illness, elderly, or a family that just wants a quick, delicious drink, try Dr. Bill Deagle's Life Support for optimized nutrition in one great-tasting smoothie. Just add cold water, almond milk, fruit, or anything else you like. NutriMedical's Life Support. Try our great-tasting chocolate or vanilla today. Call 888-212-8871 or visit us online at NutriMedical.com. NutriMedical.com for the whole family.
rules on Freedom Fiends with Michael Dean. GCN.
With SRN News, I'm Ron DeRockstra. A suspect's in jail facing capital murder charges in the death of a Harris County, Texas sheriff's deputy. Harris County Sheriff Ron Hickman says investigators worked hard to track down the suspect.
All of the family members of the Harris County Sheriff's Office, our local law enforcement partners, as well as our state and federal came together and we're proud that we're able to resolve this in a timely manner.
Hickman says the suspect, 30-year-old Shannon J. Miles, has a criminal history.
He does have previous criminal history that includes charges for resisting arrest, trespass, evading detention, and disorderly conduct with a firearm.
Hickman says it appears that Deputy Darren Goforth was murdered simply because he was a cop. Also at SRNnews.com, parts of Florida can expect heavy rain and wind starting tomorrow due to the remnants of Erica.
Basically, the whole southern part of the peninsula and the Florida Keys is no real localized place that's going to get the worst of it.
Jack Bevan with the National Hurricane Center. Erica's blamed for at least 20 deaths on the island, where nearly 50 others are reported missing. 5 deaths on Haiti also attributed to the storm. Speaking of storms, a tropical storm watch being issued for the Big Island of Hawaii. Forecaster Tom Burchard says the current track suggests that Hurricane Ignacio will only deliver a glancing blow to the islands, but is still one to watch.
Any sort of deviation to the left of the official forecast track would bring more severe conditions to the main Hawaiian islands. So we're still preaching for folks in the islands to keep a close eye on the forecast over the next couple of days.
Currently, Ignacio is a Category 4 hurricane with winds nearing 140 miles an hour. A shark that was seen circling kayakers has led lifeguards to close a San Diego County beach. A 1.5-mile stretch from La Jolla Cove to Scripps Pier was closed Saturday after a confirmed sighting of the 8- to 10-foot hammerhead shark was spotted in the water. This is SRN News.
America was built by people with a few dollars and a dream. And while many don't know it, there's one path to success that still only requires a dream and about $10. That's right. If your dream is to start or grow your business, something as simple as the right business card could make all the difference. And today, at Vistaprint.com, you can get 500 full-color business cards for only $9.99. That's right, 500 business cards for just $9.99. What's more, you can choose between hundreds of designs or upload your own and customize them easily. And because they're from Vistaprint.com, the cards are of top quality and your satisfaction is 100% guaranteed. So visit Vistaprint.com today and get 500 shots at turning your dream into reality. Hurry, because this offer won't last long. To get your 500 business cards for just $9.99, go to Vistaprint.com, click on the link in the upper right corner, and use promo code 2323. That's Vistaprint.com, click on the link in the upper right corner, and use promo code 2323.
The minimum wage in St. Louis will rise to $11 per hour by 2018 under a newly approved measure.
The bill approved Friday by St. Louis's Board of Aldermen and later signed by Mayor Francis Slay was a compromise. An original proposal sought to raise the minimum wage to $13 an hour by 2020. Several cities have been increasing their minimum wage. The vote on the contentious issue met an important deadline. In July, Missouri Democratic Governor Jay Nixon vetoed a bill that would have blocked cities from raising the minimum wage beyond the state's $7.65 per hour minimum. Lawmakers could override Nixon's veto during a special September session. Patrick Voss reporting.
A hearing is set for Monday for a South Carolina mother who drove her 3 children into the ocean off Daytona Beach. Ebony Wilkerson's been in a state psychiatric hospital after a judge ruled last year she was incompetent to stand trial and could be a threat to herself or to others. The 3 children are in state custody. This is SRN News. It was on August 29, 1949.
At a remote test site in Kazakhstan, the USSR successfully detonated its first atomic bomb, codenamed First Lightning. In order to measure the effects of the blast, the Soviet scientists constructed buildings and other civilian structures. They also placed animals in cages nearby so they could test the effects of nuclear radiation on human-like mammals. The atomic explosion at 20 kilotons destroyed those structures and incinerated the animals. Val Dior, SRN News.
Powerful winds toppled trees and power lines across the Pacific Northwest Saturday, causing 2 deaths in the Seattle area, knocking out electricity to at least 250,000 customers in Oregon and Washington. One man was killed when a tree fell on his car in Gig Harbor. A 10-year-old girl was killed in Federal Way, northeast of Tacoma. More details at srnnews.com. I'm Ron DeRockstra.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24-7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Okay, open your mouth and say ah.
Ah.
When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor-recommended Say-Ah Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical-grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to sayahnow.com. Sayahnow.com, the new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us here toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's the number, 855-450-3733. Joining you tonight, you've got Ian.
And Mark.
Teenager has been sentenced to 11 years in prison. This happened yesterday for providing so-called material support to terrorism. And by that, apparently that means running a Twitter account that celebrated the terrorist group ISIS and taught others how to send them money through Bitcoin. The case, according to Andrew McCabe, assistant director in charge of the FBI's Washington field office, in a statement says that Amin's case serves as a reminder of how persistent and pervasive online radicalization has become. The FBI, through our joint terrorism task forces, remains dedicated to protecting the United States against the ongoing violent threat posed by ISIL and their supporters. Even though, of course, this young man didn't ever conduct a single act of violence, he might have applauded someone else's acts of violence. He might have helped others understand how to possibly send money to support those acts of violence, but he himself didn't actually commit any acts of violence, and now he's going to prison for 11 years. It's crazy. Yeah.
Well, I don't know if it's crazy. It seems a very reasonable thing to have happened. One thing that
What part is reasonable?
Well, it's reasonable because it's pretty obvious he picked a team while enjoying the life that is provided here in the United States, right? Like, he picked the site of ISIS without moving there. What he should have done as a 17-year-old is picked up his life and moved to the Islamic State, and then he should have done all the Twittering and all these things that he would have, all the propaganda. Because the United States has put no one that I am aware of in prison that has been, giving out positive ISIS materials who are actually in that area, the Levant.
Well, I'm really disappointed in you tonight, Mark, because I thought you were for free speech, and it sounds to me like you think that this guy is just getting what he deserves. Oh, how dare he support ISIS in the United States? He should have gone somewhere else, and this is not a free country. You shouldn't be able to speak freely in the United States if you're criticizing the government.
Well, I think that he's not criticizing the government. He's advocating for another one. Mm-hmm. And you see, that's really the crux of it here. He's not advocating for freedom. He's advocating actually for the opposite. And that's one of the issues that I have with the situation. Treason is not the advocation of the destruction of the current state, it's more the evocation for the rule of another state. And so in this case, that's sort of what he's done. And treason is an issue of the transference of information. Just about all the crimes of treason out there have to do with people who are transferring information to others, not so much people who are, fighting one side or another.
The definition of treason doesn't include what you just mentioned, the idea that you are supporting someone else's state. Certainly that could be seen as treasonous, but, the definition of it here, according to dictionary.com, is noun, the offense of acting to overthrow one's government or to harm or kill its sovereign. 2, a violation of allegiance to one's sovereign
or to one's state.
Yeah, I think that that could... So, frankly,
anarchists could be considered treasonous as well.
Frankly, anybody who's against any other, any government agency at all, according to that definition.
And
right?
Anybody who speaks in opposition to any state or in favor of another state, I think should have protected free speech in the United States. You could share your thoughts at 855-450-FREE, but maybe I'm in the minority. Jake is in Greenwood, Indiana, listening to, I believe, WIBC. Hello, Jake. Do we have Jake in Greenwood? Jake in Greenwood going once. Jake in Greenwood going twice. Maybe there's a technical difficulty. We'll try Adam in St. George, Utah. Do we have Adam in St. George?
Yeah, hey, how you guys doing?
Welcome, Adam. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Yeah, I just wanted to say I just moved here to St. George and found your guys' radio station, and I love it. I think that you guys really bring up some awesome stuff that you talk about. And I think it's really interesting how we're talking about free speech. And I don't know, I just think it's interesting how we say that that kid should go to jail because he committed treason or whatever for supporting and aiding the enemy or whatever. But if you look at guys like Patrick Henry and the Founding Fathers, they were British citizens, and they fought and advocated against the British government using speech. And that's why we have the 10 Amendments to the Constitution, and especially why free speech is so important, is because they understood when your government becomes corrupt, you have to have the ability to speak out against your government. And so I think it's ridiculous that we're at the point where we're justifying sending people to jail for speaking out against their government or speaking for groups that aren't against the government. I can understand if you're supplying bombs to ISIS or something like that, then that would be treason. But anyway, free speech, I don't know, I just don't think a lot of people get it anymore. And I wanted to talk about one other thing, just make one point. I think it's really interesting, speaking about foreign policy, how whenever 9/11 happened, George Bush came out and he was like basically saying, it's horrible. Terrorism is the worst it's ever been. We've never seen anything like this. And I just want to point out that whenever we first came to this country, look at what we did to the Indians. We came in, we took over their lands, and they raided our settlements. They scalped the men, raped the women and the mothers, and burned the houses with the children. And I don't know what you would call that if it's not terrorism. So it's nothing new. It's what happens when you invade other people's lands and tell them what to do. So I just think we're doing ourselves an injustice whenever we pick a group of people like Latinos, or whenever we say the Muslims are all terrorists, and we're the ones over there bombing them and destroying their homes, and we killed hundreds of thousands of citizens. And if a country came into our country and did what we're doing over in the Middle East, then we would be attacking that country as hard as we could.
Oh, and people would be livid. And that's why I asked the guy earlier, how he would feel if the Chinese decided to start bombing his neighborhood. And he gave the correct answer. That is that he would be really pissed off and, you know, he'd want to do something about it.
Right.
Well, guess what? They're pretty mad, too, that the U.S. government is bombing their neighborhoods. So you're right on, Adam. Thanks for the call tonight. Glad you found Free Talk Live.
Yeah, I think that many Americans it's very difficult for them to stand in the shoes of what it must be like for people around the world.
I can't imagine what it would be like to be a victim of bombing. That sounds absolutely horrifying.
Even if you just think that it could happen to you, right? Like if you're in the geographic area of Waziristan or Yemen or a variety of places, the potential of death from the sky is pretty high, or at least it's there. Right here in the United States, there have been no one that I know of has been killed by a bomb drop from remote control airplane. But it happens over there, and the wrong house is sometimes hit. The wrong people are sometimes killed.
And when you say sometimes, you mean hundreds of thousands of innocent people have perished. I know the...
Not from drone bombings.
Well, I'm just talking about the U.S. government over there in general attacking people. Wasn't the Iraq body count up to a few hundred thousand or something
like
that?
Certainly the State Department's numbers are more than 100,000 non-combatants were killed.
Let's talk to Mike in Nowhere, Tennessee. Mike, you're on Free Talk Live.
Good morning. The issue I wanted to talk about was giving you some facts about the situation, which was apparently a staged shooting in Virginia.
Are you serious with this? Go ahead. I want to hear it. What do you got?
Well, let's just look at the facts. Number one, if this is to be a shooting where the cameraman is literally, and anybody that's a cameraman knows this, those close-up shots occur because you're literally a foot away from the person's face. You don't zoom in. Those cameras don't have a zoom, okay?
What are you talking about? Wait. You're talking about the man with a gun, his camera?
No, sir, listen to me. Before you interrupt me and throw me off, listen to me.
Well, if you're going to be given misinformation on the air, I'm going to interrupt you and stop you. I am a camera man. I have a video camera, and I've operated professional video cameras, and they absolutely have a zoom on them. What are you talking about? I mean, this is just ridiculous from the start. But go ahead, point number two.
Did you see the camera that the camera operator was using, not the gunman?
Yes, I did.
Okay. Does that camera have a zoom?
Pretty much every – I can't identify the model of camera from the gunman's video.
When you do your homework, you'll find that it does not have a zoom.
Ridiculous.
There is no way that the cameraman could have got a full body shot.
What kind of professional video camera doesn't have a zoom on it? I have never heard of this.
Most of them do not. Professional ones do not have a zoom. Anyway, but you know, you're the professional, but look at the photograph of this guy. It's a full body image. You would have had to have been 15 feet away to get a full body image with that camera. Okay, number two, the woman, Allison Parks, she has the dark eyes. She has the bleach blonde hair. Her father.
All right, I got to know what the point of all this is. Why did they fake the shooting? Stand by, Mike, this shooting this week in Virginia of the news reporter. Ridiculous.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Friends, this is Alex Jones for MidasResources.com. For more than 15 years, I have exclusively used Midas Resources for all my precious metal needs. Whether it's bullion or collectibles you're looking for, Midas Resources is simply the best. I own my gold as a hedge against inflation. This Federal Reserve fiat currency could go the way of the Deutschmark and the Weimar Republic anytime. In these historically dangerous times, it makes sense to physically hold gold and silver. Midas already has some of the best deals in the industry. But if you give them a call and mention the radio special, they will give you a list of the day's super specials. Midas brokers are standing by to answer all your questions at 800-686-2237. They also have a lot of informative free literature explaining the opportunities and risk of holding precious metals. They are ready to answer your questions at 800-686-2237. Again, that's 800-686-2237.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey system. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting GoBerkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
Sciatica, lower back pain, hip pain, poor posture. If you suffer from any of these problems, get ready to relax. Introducing an amazing product that's been in the market for over 25 years, the Sacro Wedgie. It was invented by a football coach using a common sense osteopath technique. He created this device to help his athletes by isolating and supporting the sacrum, which is the keystone of our anatomy. This wedge-shaped bone is in the center of our hips, where a lot of pain starts. Simply relax 20 minutes daily on the amazingly simple Sacro Wedgie and let gravity do the work, helping muscles rebalance and start releasing nerves. Sit in the sacro wedgie at the computer or while traveling to help correct posture to finally help relieve those stubborn aches and pains for only $33.95. It's made in the USA, so click the family-owned website at sacrowedgie.com, spelled S-A-C-R-O-W-E-D-G-Y.com, or call 1-800-737-9295. That's 1-800-737-9295. Relax your back pain away with the sacro wedgie.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Yeah! It's Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition. You can dial toll-free, and you can bring up any kind of poppycock nonsense that you want here. Really. That's what the guy who actually did hang on. We're going to bring him back on here in a moment. He's calling to tell us that he believes that this Virginia shooting that happened this week, that made headlines and happened on live television, this horrible shooting of a man, shooting a cameraman and a journalist, just absolutely shocking. That's what happened. But he's saying that it's a conspiracy theory, that it was faked or a false flag or whatever. We'll get to his theory here in a moment. Bitcoinist.net is the ultimate resource for Bitcoin industry news, reviews, education, and the latest in the cryptocurrency ecosystem. At Bitcoinist.net, they have a community forum breaking Bitcoin and digital currency news, fintech and blockchain news, plus sophisticated Bitcoin network statistics, a solid beginner's guide to Bitcoin, and more. The Bitcoinist platform serves the needs of everyone looking to keep up with Bitcoin and digital currencies. From beginners to experts, Bitcoinist.net, that's Bitcoinist.net. And we will continue here. Mike calling from nowhere, Tennessee. First, he makes the ridiculous claim that professional video cameras have no zoom, that most of them have no zoom. I've never heard of that before, and I've
the internet certainly brings up some professional cameras with zooms.
Right. Why you would want to buy a camera that will cost you thousands, tens of thousands of dollars in certain cases, why you would not want that to have the most basic of features of a video camera, which is a zoom lens. I don't understand that, but let's not get bogged down in that claim for a moment, Mike.
You just said the operative word, lens. The camera doesn't have a zoom. The lens does. He doesn't have a zoom lens. Okay, You just answered my question. Give me 20 seconds, and you'll get all the facts. I don't deal in conspiracies. I deal in facts. Number one, No blood at the scene. No recoil of the woman when she's supposed to be shot. She would have recoiled if she'd been hit. No recoil of the camera in his other hand. We're supposed to believe he's shooting. Mm-hmm. A pistol, and he's able to hold it so smoothly, there's no recoil. Not going to happen. Number two,
9mm. Not very.
You're saying he was shooting a. You're saying, sir, that he was shooting a. Yeah. Okay, so.
The woman has brown eyes and bleached blonde hair. She has a pertussis, which is a Native American condition. She is not related to those two people. No emotion by the father in the event. 2 hours later, he did an interview.
What do you think this was all about?
No emotion by the mother. No emotion by the boyfriend, whose video, if you look at the clock on the video in the middle.
I've heard enough, okay? There's websites where I'm sure people can go and listen to this nonsense. Look, what is your theory then for why this shooting happened? How did they convince this man to go and shoot these people? Or are you going to say it wasn't the person who they say did it?
Who knows the reason why they do these things, other than to take away. The father, the very next day, says he's going to make his lifelong mission to eliminate the gun show.
So?
Where people can
are you guns. Surprised by that? Are you shocked about that? I mean, most parents, when their kids are killed, come out with statements like that about how they want to restrict more people's freedom.
No, sir, you're wrong. I've known people that have lost children in different events, and they are so beside themselves, they can't come out.
I mean, the fact that you can watch video footage of people, being threatened and shot, and then say, oh, well, that didn't happen the way I saw it happen. I mean, it's just absolutely bizarre to me.
You're not using your brain because there's no blood, there's no recoil.
Were you at the scene of the crime, sir? Did you clean it up?
You don't have to be there to look at the evidence they've already shown you.
What evidence? The evidence of a cell phone video or a GoPro or whatever? I mean, that's not exactly the highest resolution. No. And besides that, when you watch the shooting of these people... All right, I've had enough. Thanks, Mike, for the call. When you watch the video of this, Mark, did you ever get around to
seeing it? Yeah, I watched the video, sadly.
He clearly misses the first shot.
clearly misses the first shot, and there's a good chance he missed the second and third shots as well. I mean, it's true, the woman turns around and runs away, and I can understand why someone would think, oh, well, if you were shot, you wouldn't exactly turn around and run away, but there have been instances of people who've been shot, and they don't even know they're shot.
It's a 9mm. It's not exactly known for its stopping power.
Right.
From what I've heard from people who've been in situations like this is that you would be surprised how little blood there is, and that that people tend to react entirely different than the television.
This isn't TV.
Yeah. This isn't movies.
Right. I mean, you're expecting the blood pack to go off in their chest and like spray everything everywhere. And I'm sorry, it's not an R-rated movie.
Look, I'm willing to listen to facts on things as best I can. The guy didn't get to really give them out very well.
Oh, but he gave out a bunch of them. I've heard.
Yeah, I wasn't impressed with what I did hear. I'm sick of people coming up with conspiracy theory every time something bad happens.
Yes, look, ridiculous.
Bad things happen in the world.
Right. The idea that there are no crazy people out there who are just acting on their own volition, that it's all a part of some sort of government conspiracy theory. Get out of the basement sometime, okay? And get into the real world.
The government's full of people, and people sometimes do bad things. And besides, that's what our lizard shape-shifting overlords have made us say.
Let's talk to Dave listening in Virginia Beach to WNIS. Hello, Dave.
Hey, guys. How you doing?
Welcome, sir. You're on the air.
Another day in paradise. Yeah, it was interesting because I had heard some information a couple of weeks ago where some folks were, the feds were looking at them because they were planning on traveling over to Syria, I guess, to join up with ISIS. And as a result, they were detained and arrested. Just on the assumption that that's what they were going to do. And then your solution to the guy that ended up recently getting jail time for sending out information on ISIS was that he should have traveled over there and into an environment where it was more conducive to his thought process. But, you know, once again, I don't know how you can be arrested for them assuming that you're going to travel over in order to join a group.
It's a thought crime. It's a thought crime. I mean, even if you did give evidence, like even if you posted on the internet, I'm going to go join ISIS, and then you bought a plane ticket, it's still a thought crime until you actually go join ISIS and then hurt somebody. I think you should be able to join ISIS and get the hell out of there once you've realized you've made a huge mistake and not have to go to prison when you come home, you know, realizing that you've blown it. I mean, that's going to be a punishment enough.
Yeah, that's my thought process too. It's like if you want to be stupid enough to go over there and take your chances with them or getting taken out by, once again, you know, a drone or whatever. But
well, I suspect ISIS is one of those organizations that once you join, you don't exactly get to leave. So if somebody you know, joins and tries to leave, they're going to have ISIS after them, and apparently they'll have the U.S. government after them. Hey, Dave, thanks for your call. Go ahead.
Yeah, are you still there?
Yep. Go ahead.
What's the end result of a thought crime when it gets prosecuted? Do people will they actually be convicted?
Oh, he's been convicted. He's going to this 17-year-old is going to prison for 11 years.
I'm talking about the people folks that have been arrested for the fact that they were planning on traveling over there.
They'll go to prison too.
The feds thought they were going to go over to join ISIS and arrested them.
Well, they'll go in front of a jury. And the feds will do their best to make them look like they were going to do that, and likely the jury will agree with the feds because juries are docile and obedient, and they do what they're told. So I suspect they'll probably end up behind bars as well. Dave, thanks for the call tonight. Our toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE, and we've got time for you if you want to join us here on the live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live. Whether it's ridiculous conspiracy theory or whatever happens to be on your mind, maybe you want to talk about the ISIS thing, 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral. Don't take on the IRS alone. I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill. Sometimes I can even get it zeroed out completely.
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral.
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180. Just recently, we've witnessed some of the most catastrophic disasters in history. Be sure to prepare yourself with great-tasting, high-quality, GMO-free food that has a 25-year shelf life. Of course, we're talking about the foods from SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. And don't forget, the human body needs up to 3 quarts of water every day to remain healthy and hydrated. So check out our water bricks at SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. Go to SurvivalFoodAlliance.com or call 877-223-1776.
Is negative content or comments on the web affecting your personal or professional reputation? Unfavorable comments, embarrassing pictures, videos, legal documents, and bad tweets can ruin your personal life, your career, or your business. It happens a lot, and it's just not fair. But what can you do? Reputation.com can protect your good name. Get a free consultation now at 800-831-0771. That's 800-831-0771. Call right now for a free expert reputation analysis. It's easy to squash the unfair attacks with our patented system, and the analysis is absolutely free. Make the best things about you jump out in searches. Protect your personal and professional reputation, your business, and your income. Get your free reputation analysis from Reputation.com right now. Call 800-831-0771. 800-831-0771. 800-831-0771.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
If you're worried about your health and you're tired of the nasty side effects of harsh drugs or antibiotics, then look no further. Supernatural Silver is the answer. Supernatural Silver is a powerful immune system enhancer that can be used every day to help keep you healthy and well with none of those nasty side effects. It's extremely safe for use internally as well as topically. And Supernatural Silver is hundreds of times more effective than colloidal or ionic silver. It is perfect for use in the sinuses, eyes, ears, and on any wound or skin issue. Supernatural Silver is also extremely effective when taken orally and can help fight off bacteria, viruses, and mold that may be overwhelming your immune system. Go to SupernaturalSilver.com. SupernaturalSilver.com and use the promo code Silver2015 for 30% off of your entire order and give yourself and your loved ones a fighting chance with Supernatural Silver.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24-7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition. Of course, you can join us here. Our toll free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. It is Ian here with you.
And Mark.
A very ridiculously dressed Mark who
it's
is
King Mark to you.
He has donned, no, it is not. He has donned a robe of some sort. What do you call that? A shawl? What is that?
I don't know what kings wear. It's a king, mantle.
A kingly, yeah, there you go. Kingly mantle. He has a very silly hat with a very big red stone emblazoned on the,
yep,
on the front.
Yep. You can see it at cam.freetalklive.com.
You can. I'll actually put the camera right on you because you were given this from our friend Derek J. Freeman.
Who, yeah, he gave me the mantle. The crown that he gave me can't really be worn with headphones, so I've got my own plush crown that I bought for just this purpose.
It was a going-away gift from our buddy Derek J., yeah, who is heading out on a new journey in his life. Those of you who've listened to the show for a while, you know and you love Derek J., likely. And, of course, you can always grab him on his video, Derek J.'s Victimless Crime Spree, which you can go and watch for free anytime at victimlesscrimespree.com. Of course, it's sad to see him go, but he is, I think, going to be having a good time out in San Francisco, which is his destination, and I'm sure we'll see him back here. Actually, he says he's coming back for Keenvention, so that's exciting.
Really? That soon? That
yeah,
quickly?
Yeah, that's right. Because Keenvention's that good of an event, Mark. It's going to draw him all the way back here from California. He's awesome like that. So go check out more of Derek J. Freeman, our good friend and former co-host here on Free Talk Live, over at victimlesscrimespree.com and his website, thederekj.com. Right back to your phone calls and thoughts. Let's go to Jake, listening in Greenwood. Jake, do we actually have you this time? I think we had some technical difficulties before.
Yeah, I'm sorry about that. I'm here.
Welcome, sir. Go ahead with your thoughts.
You know, I called to discuss one topic, but being on hold and listening to these past few callers, I'm actually going to talk about something else.
Sure.
There was a caller a couple calls ago named Craig, and he said that he feels that us as Americans shouldn't be tracked. And I'm wondering, is there anybody else out there who believes that we're actually already being tracked? I mean, the government can, you know, tap into our phones, tap into our IP addresses, and view damn near anything they want.
Yep, that's true.
I think that no matter who you vote for, if you vote for, you know, Trump, by all means, please don't. But if you vote for Trump, you vote for Clinton, you vote for Sanders, whoever you vote for, this electoral college is going to elect whoever they want to be as this leader. And I feel like we really don't have a say-so. And as free as we think we are, in my opinion, we're, you know, just one or two advancements away from slavery. I mean, I feel
well,
like...
Well, generally,
really
the electoral college votes in the way they're supposed to vote. But I guess you're right. They could
Potentially,
do whatever they wanted.
I kind of... The way I feel about voting is that it's essentially, especially when you talk about presidential elections, you're talking about something that's mathematically insignificant. So I know in 2008, Barack Obama took New Hampshire by 60,000 votes. Now, if I was able to retract my vote or change my vote or do whatever it was, it wouldn't change the fact that there's no way I could change what the outcome here in New Hampshire was for those four electoral college votes. I couldn't do anything, right? Like, I could vote for Barack Obama, I could vote for McCain, I could vote for whoever was running for the Libertarian, Bob Barr. I could vote for a variety of people in that election, and it wouldn't change the outcome because I am mathematically disenfranchised
from
the process.
Even if it did change the outcome, it wouldn't matter anyway. I think that's what Jake's getting at here, is that it doesn't matter who wins, we're going to lose.
No, Jake's saying that the Electoral College is the one who ultimately makes the decision, and that is a true statement.
Well, but I think he was making a larger statement, Mark. Maybe you weren't paying attention.
Both.
Yeah, right.
A little bit of both. Yeah, like, who is this supposed electoral college that votes? I mean, if things weren't supposed to hit the fan, then the electoral college wouldn't have voted Bush. And, I mean, I'm somewhat a conspiracy theorist, too. I know there are people who lost family members in 9/11, but, I mean, who's to say that that wasn't us? I mean, I'm not trying to start a topic and go off and just bash 9/11 and all this
well,
and that.
Well, we know it wasn't us because we weren't in the planes and we're here right now talking. But I think you mean the United States, people from the government, et cetera. But I agree with you that definitely whoever it is that wins the election, whether Republican or Democrat, the U.S. is going to become a more enslaved nation over that time frame. It doesn't matter who wins. And we're already in slavery. It's just a more subtle form of it. It's not like chattel slavery where there's a man with a whip standing behind you or, you know, on a horse behind you as you're slaving in a field. Now the men have guns and uniforms and they drive cars and they're called police. And they will enforce the rules on us on this big, large plantation called the United States. And if you don't do what Master says, Master being the federal government or your state governments, then they will hurt you and they'll put you in a cage and they'll humiliate you. And if if you've got to turn over the money that you earn to somebody else to decide what to do with, you're their slave, right?
Well, I got one more thing to say before I get off this line, and people might want to deny it, people might have never heard of it, people might not believe it, but I just got three letters for you, and that's NWO, and you might want to Google those, and you might want to Google martial law, because that's going to take its course here pretty soon, and we are going to be a militarized country, and we're not going to be able to leave this place, and things are going to be bad.
Thanks for your call, Jake. I don't know about the whole NWO thing. I mean, I see where people are coming from with that. I think that that's a distraction, but I agree with him that the police state is certainly on the rise. There's evidence for that. That's crystal clear. That is happening. And the people that want to stop immigration or whatever, or crack down on the supposed illegal immigrants, they're the ones who are going to usher in an even greater police state with even more checkpoints, house-to-house searches, businesses being raided. That's a lot of those things are already happening.
Yeah, they're not going to declare martial law because they don't have to declare martial law. What if you think about the marathon bombers there in Boston when they went hunting for those guys? They didn't declare martial law when they drove military vehicles into the streets of the United States.
They just did it.
They put a curfew, essentially a 24-hour curfew down, locked everybody in their houses, and then did house-to-house searches. They didn't declare martial law because they don't care to.
Let's go on here. We've got Michael. He is in Panama City. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Michael.
I promise to be better than the Michael from Tennessee.
Welcome, sir. Go ahead.
I want to go ahead and talk about the 17-year-old, which is what you originally started the hour out by.
Yes.
He actually stood up for what he did because he knew what he did was wrong. Freedom of speech, yeah, that's fine. But when you use it to facilitate, help financially, and he also helped people get to Syria. Okay, he knew what he was doing was wrong. Didn't even convict him. They didn't even convict him. He actually pled guilty.
Okay.
And so that's what I'm trying to say to you. He even stood up for what he did, knowing that it was wrong.
Well, I think that the vast majority of people in the United States plead guilty. There are, sadly,
especially that's the being an adult about it and knowing what you did wrong and knowing you got caught.
It's not wrong to
speak.
Do
you believe that people that take pleas are being an adult about it? Because I have to take issue with that. I'm not talking about this particular circumstance but I mean what you're saying concerns me greatly. And the reason is because it's in this country where you're supposed to have your day in court, you're talking about the vast majority. Far larger than 99% of people who are arrested never see their day in court because the system is so stacked against them. I would say that the plea bargain is, in fact, an un-American, fundamentally un-American idea. The only people it benefits are guilty people who get lower sentences and government bureaucrats paid to do a job that they're not having to do, which is lawyers.
What about court time? What about court time and aggravation and disappointment to bring a jury in there and take it through 7 or 8 steps of convicting a guy that knows he did wrong?
Well, that's
both sides are getting a trade-off for a plea bargain.
Those sides aren't my concern.
The person doesn't tie up the court system for 3 months. And start serving his due because he did wrong, and the state doesn't have to deal with how do I got to prove what we've already proved enough to get him arrested.
I don't really care what the outcomes are for guilty people or government bureaucrats we're supposed to be paying to get justice out of. Those people are supposed to have to go through the court system.
Hey, Michael, should I be able to publish bomb-making instructions on the internet?
Yeah, you can. You can go ahead and publish them all you want.
But if I publish bomb-making instructions saying you should use these bombs to attack American troops or to help ISIS, then all of a sudden it's a crime?
Nope. But I tell you what, teaching somebody how to send money to them and teaching somebody how to physically get over there, those are illegal.
Free speech, man. Free speech. Thanks for the call. 855-450-FREE. You don't support free speech, then don't be surprised when yours gets restricted too.
This message is for home intruders, the cowards who break into people's homes to steal their hard-earned property, criminals who shatter lives and rob people of their privacy and security. Listen very carefully. We're the home security experts at LiveWatch, and we're taking you down. Because we're letting everyone try our newest home security system for 1 full year in their home. To take advantage of this amazing offer, call now, 1-800-670-9259. LiveWatch has been helping protect homes for years, and we've learned the secrets that intruders like you don't want people to know. Criminals, it's time for you to be afraid, because every person who calls will be protected against cowards like you. To the criminals listening, we're taking you down. To those who want to help protect their homes, call the security experts to try the LiveWatch security system. There are no long-term contracts, and if you're not completely satisfied, you can cancel at any time. Try LiveWatch now by calling 1-800-670-9259. That's 1-800-670-9259.
You are an individual with your own thoughts, decisions, and actions. So why should you be penalized for not enrolling in the subpar health insurance mandated by the government? Be truly independent. Visit LibertyOnCall.org. LibertyOnCall.org is a bold, innovative alternative allowing you to take back control and make your own decisions about your health care. Mention this ad when you call to learn more. 800-714-6993. That's 800-714-6993. LibertyOnCall.org. Call today.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
Hi, this is Walt Augustinowicz. I'm the founder and CEO of ID Stronghold. By now you've heard our commercials about wallets that protect you from electronic pickpocketing. 10 years ago, I created a way to protect my own cards from prying eyes after government officials started talking about issuing a national ID card with a built-in radio chip called RFID. I felt having to broadcast my personal information was an invasion of privacy. Soon after, it was also announced that credit cards, debit cards, U.S. passports, hotel room keys, and even transit passes would all soon incorporate RFID. It was then I formed ID Stronghold to share my inventions in blocking RFID signals with the world. There are a lot of misconceptions out there today about RFID. I encourage everyone to get informed and get protected. Please go to IDStronghold.com and get the facts and the wallet, sleeves, or badge holders you need to protect your personal financial data. You'll be pleasantly surprised that through our direct sales model, you won't pay more than other comparable unprotected wallets. It is as though the protection is free. Visit IDStronghold.com today.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live. I will not give you the phone lines at this point because the phones are loaded. And it is the remaining moments of the live Saturday edition. If you don't get on with us here tonight, don't worry. We've got a Sunday show that we do as well. Even if it's not carried on your local radio station, you can always listen online anytime you like over at freetalklive.com. Now, our live hours are 7 to 10 at night Eastern Time, 7 nights a week. So some of you are listening on the radio, you're listening later on. You might be listening to this tomorrow or whatever. Of course, when you're listening to it, it'll be today, but it'll be yesterday, etc. Anyway, we're delayed broadcast, and if you want to join the show live, then you can call us, even if you aren't listening live at that time. So tomorrow night, we will be doing a live Sunday show, just as we do every single night. Of course, you can join us online anytime you want at freetalklive.com.
So at my house, we've come up with a solution for this whole Obamacare thing. For us, the costs of health care have gone up, and we needed a solution. The solution that we found was Liberty Health Share. So what a health share is something different than insurance. It's people who are sharing with each other the burdens of health care. And it's completely legal, you know, above the board. The health shares have been around for a very long time. And they allow us to do this in an efficient fashion. And for us, it's about almost half the cost. I wouldn't say half the cost, just above half the cost, but only marginally above half the cost. If you want to get involved, at least check it out. If you're paying for your own health care, you should consider this. LibertyHealthShare.org. LibertyHealthShare.org. I'll give you the telephone number, too. People who can't go on the internet right now. 1-855-58-LIBERTY. That's 855-58-LIBERTY, libertyhealthshare.org.
To the phones, to the fun. Robert, listening in Indy to WIBC. Hello, Robert.
Hey, yeah, this is me, Robert.
Welcome, you're on the air.
Thanks. Yeah, it's the first time listening to you guys. It's an amazing show.
Thanks.
Awesome. So I wanted to share with you about a friend of mine. His name is Sam Bradbury from Lafayette, Indiana. He got, I don't know if you heard about his case or whatever, but he got arrested last year or the year before for making terroristic threats on Facebook. He was going to blow up the courthouse and kill some cops. And he, like, claimed allegiance with those cop killers out in Las Vegas.
Mm. Yeah, it's been some time.
Interesting.
Yeah, that's been some time, yeah.
Yeah, so what's interesting is that, you know, he's been sitting in jail. I don't think they've actually, like, sentenced him to prison or anything, but he's not going to get 11 years. And that kid, like, 17 years old, is probably going to do 11 years for basically just giving information. And this guy was actually making threats. And, you know, they raided his house and found bomb-making materials and stuff. And he's probably, I mean, not going to get 11 years. So that seems kind of weird and fucked up to me.
Oh, you can't say that on the radio. Sorry, dude. We're doing a live radio show and... I see where he's coming from, though. It is effed up that what is happening with these free speech attacks. I did pull up the Sam Bradbury story he was referring to. He actually was convicted, found guilty in this Facebook threat case back in July of this year. The post that he made, supposedly where he intended to kill four public officials and destroy public property, including the courthouse, the post, which is to parents, friends, and attorneys, defended as satire, articulated plans to, quote, purge the vile pig scum from this land and restore constitutional rights to the people. He'd been indicted initially on one federal charge, willfully making a threat to use fire or explosives. The second charge was added in May, alleging that he maliciously conveyed false information in an attempt to carry out an attack with fire or explosives. But he didn't actually attack anyone with fire or explosives. And I don't think an angry Facebook post that was likely written in response to something that the awful government did should result in somebody going to prison.
It sounds like he's upset with Muslims, didn't he?
I didn't read his actual post, so I couldn't tell you about it. It sounds like he's upset with the government in this man's case. And, of course, you know, when you go against the government, they go against you as hard as they possibly can.
Oftentimes that's the case.
I wish we had more time to look into it, but we don't at the moment. Let's continue with your calls and thoughts. George, listening in Pennsylvania, you're on Free Talk Live. Hello, George.
Hey, I want to say I love this country. It's the best country in the world, and I believe in free speech. But I will not let free speech let me publish or say things that would be detrimental to the safety of this country and its citizens. That's all I got to say.
Well, so then you don't believe in free speech then. So you don't get an exception to free speech.
I said, oh, yes, you do.
No, you don't. It's either free or it's not, sir.
It's, these people that do things against this country that would be detrimental in their speech and publish things should move out of this country and go somewhere.
I'm not going anywhere, and it is my goal to do whatever I can to be the detriment to the United States.
You liberals are all the same. You talk in circles, and you ain't going to change my mind.
Sir, I am not a liberal, nor am I a conservative. You don't even know who you're talking to. Thank you for the call tonight. I am a liberty-minded person. I believe in freedom. I think you should be free to live your life how you want, so long as you do not harm anybody else. And the U.S. federal government and your local state and local governments are doing harm to peaceful people on a regular basis, and I will say and do whatever I can to undermine their legitimacy as much as I possibly can, and I'm going to do it right here from my studio in Keene, New Hampshire. Because I already have moved for more freedom. I moved here as part of the Free State Project, which you can learn more about if you love liberty, unlike that last guy, at freestateproject.org. Let's go to Scott, listening in Wilmington. Scott, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, how you doing?
Welcome, sir.
Well, the last caller, I'm not a liberal, and I'm a member of the Leave Me the Blank Alone party. but the Founding Fathers, for that last call, the Founding Fathers were all radicals, and they were all of the mind that free speech and even talk against the government was protected speech, that you should speak out against your government if it's if it's doing things that goes against the Constitution and against freedom and liberty. But I think with that guy out in that got arrested, I think they found bomb making materials at his house. So that, I mean, his threats made it a credible threat, I would think.
Still, though, I mean, you know, like I said, I haven't read his threats, so I don't know exactly what it was that he said on Facebook. I don't have that in front of me. But it shouldn't be illegal to have bomb making materials. If you did specifically say that you're going to bomb someone, specific or a specific location, I could see that as a legitimate threat. I could understand.
I see a threat
that.
As an issue, but one of the things is when I hear bomb-making materials, I'll bet you they can find something at your house and my house that would be considered bomb-making materials. And I'm always afraid of when people talk about people being caught with child porn. I'm like, well, what do they mean? Do they mean a picture of somebody who's 16, or do they mean a picture of somebody who's 16 months? And
both
I just don't
of them
know.
Would qualify under the law, unfortunately. Scott, thanks for sharing your thoughts tonight. I do appreciate hearing from you. Let's go to Chris in Charlottesville. Chris, you're on Free Talk Live. Go ahead.
Thanks a lot for taking my call. I appreciate the discussion. Just got 2 points. One is just a statement you may want to fact check. I think martial law was instituted by Nixon, and it was never taken back. But I just leave that
I've
alone.
Heard that from under Lincoln. I've heard that claim a few times.
Okay. Well, the main point I called, and this sort of a philosophical point, I think a lot of people confuse freedom with lawlessness. The ability to do whatever you want is not freedom. And I do not believe. But I believe it really comes down to the ability to discern, is there such a thing as evil? Is there a defined thing we can look at and say, no, is there a defined line between what you're free to do, what is, you know, like you said, bomb-making materials? Well, they can come in my house, they can find refrigerant and different things that can make hazing gas that could be poisonous. I mean, it gets a little fuzzy, but I think the real issue is we're really at war, and we just don't know it. We are actually at war with an ideology of Islam. And that's going on right now.
Well,
do you know
no,
why?
Sir.
But one of the reasons that the United States is at war, you say we, I'm not at war with
I'm
them.
Not
I don't want war with these people.
I like the Muslims.
One of the reasons that the United States, they may want war with me, I'll give you that. But the reason is because people in Washington, D.C. keep on effing with them. They installed the Shah of Iran in the 1950s.
You're absolutely right.
And they
right,
won't stop
the
messing
is,
with them.
You're right. But I don't think they care whether they mess with it or not. The ideology of Muslim is total.
No, sir.
That's just you guessing. We don't have any idea how they would react.
Just stop for a moment. Just stop here, right here, right now, Chris. I'm going to put you on hold because we're out of time. But to just to be painting all Muslims with a black brush like this is completely unfair. Muslims, by and far, the supermajority of them are peaceful people, peace-loving people. I like all of the Muslims that I know personally, and there may be some radicals, like there are radical Christians who are willing to do violence. Okay, we're talking about the radical ones, not an entire religion. So, out of time for tonight. But if you want to talk more.
Have you actually read the Quran?
I actually have. Yes, the entire thing.
I happen to know that, yeah.
So we'll see you tomorrow for the live Sunday edition of Free Talk Live. Enjoy your weekend and go to freetalklive.com.
If worse comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
It's fall flooring season with incredible deals on the hottest styles right now at Lumber Liquidators Fall Flooring Kickoff Sale. Choose from over 400 great floors with over 20 laminate styles like American-made mahogany for just 49 cents a square foot. More than 30 bamboo floors like carbonized bamboo for only $1.59. And over 150 hardwood floors like pre-finished gunstock oak for only 99 cents. With a dollar off Bellawood, 20% off Dream Home Laminates. Plus gray floors, woodlike tile, vinyl, and more. With 24-month special financing, the Fall Flooring Kickoff Sale is going on now. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth, slide into a recession, or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common-sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full-color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
Empowering with information. The Chris Geo Show. GCN.
92004. Don't wait.
With SRN News, I'm Ron DeRockstra. Police make an arrest in the murder of a Houston area sheriff's deputy.
Today, the district attorney's office has accepted capital murder charges on Shannon J. Miles, a black male, 915 of 84. I'd like to extend my personal thanks to District Attorney Devin Anderson and her staff, who never left our side throughout the course of this investigation.
Harris County Sheriff Ron Hickman. Deputy Darren Goforth was shot from behind as he filled up his patrol car at a gas station in Northwest Harris County Friday night. Hickman says there does not appear to be anything that provoked the attack. Also at SRNNews.com, after Erica blew through the Caribbean island of Dominica, killing at least 20 people, its remnants are passing over Cuba and are expected to move into the southeastern Gulf of Mexico Sunday. Jack Bevin with the National Hurricane Center says he can't rule out the possibility that Erica reorganizes within a couple of days.
Too early to say just how likely that is, but there's at least some possibility of that. Some of the computer models are hinting on that.
Florida Governor Rick Scott's urging citizens of South Florida to be aware of the weather this weekend.
This storm is going to come into our state sometime probably late Sunday, so watch the news. Follow your local elected officials about evacuations.
It's been a day of remembrance along the Gulf Coast, marking the 10th anniversary of the day when Hurricane Katrina struck the region. At one ceremony, former President Bill Clinton says the relief efforts after Katrina brought out the best in most people.
You had people working in the mud side by side without regard to their race, their religion, or their politics.
Some 1,800 people died in the storm, over $1 billion in damage. Michelin recalling more than 100,000 BF Goodrich tires used for light trucks and recreational vehicles. The company says the sidewalls could rupture under severe use conditions. The recall involves several types of commercial